served. This is a cooking competition where my teleprompter currently does not work. This is a cooking competition where you, the squads, control everything. You will get to vote on resources for your chefs, forced ingredients the other chefs must use, scoring categories, and sabotages to inflict on the opposing chef. Let's meet our today's chefs for today. Raphael and Echo, come on out, you two. And take your stations as well. Da, da, da. They've got music. You don't have to sing the music as well.
I'm gonna make my own music.
All right, so let's turn it over to here. So Raphael, why don't you tell the folks at home a little bit about yourself into that camera there.
Oh, hi everybody. My name is Raphael, or InstaPuff, and I do streaming on Twitch where we do coding cafe. It's all that old comfy coding. Mm-hmm. We do chat integrated projects with viewers. And so we make fun things like chat translator.
This was, and I do want to say, this is your third time on the show.
Yep.
You haven't won a round yet. Nope. Hopefully today will be the first
charm,
time for the
right?
Purple Squad, for the Purple Pirates this time around. And you are also known as the Man of a Million Microwaves. I hope you like that nickname, because that's the one I've given you, and that's what you're sticking with. Man of a Million Microwaves.
Ah.
So good luck for you. Good luck today there, Raphael. We'll come back to you in a little bit here once we start the cooking.
So
let's turn our attention over here to Echo. Echo. Who was our producer here. Why don't you tell the folks at home a little bit about yourself?
So I am Echo, the professional unicorn that you all know and love. I stream on Twitch, Echo the Space Hippie. I also am a massage therapist, a mom. I love cooking at home. I'm just kind of do a little bit of everything. So yeah.
Now Echo.
I'm here to win.
You are. I was just about to ask, how do you feel about your chances of winning today?
I feel kind of like I have a little bit of a clue of what to...
Why do you say that?
It's kind of like I've been in the back room in the show watching this happen over and over again.
Right, so you don't have an advantage or anything.
No.
And you have a cooking background as well, correct?
Well, I mean, not professional, just I've always loved cooking.
Sure.
Yeah.
So you think your chances are pretty good for the green squad here, for the green ninjas?
Absolutely.
All right.
Repping the ninjas.
Well, let's see how you fare today. So, thank you for the 5 gifted subs, by the way, from Pokemon Hero. Wow, that was really fast.
Woo!
Thank you so much.
Woo!
That's really wonderful of you. So, let's talk about the rules for Squad Says Served. Our chefs here will have 20 minutes each round to deliver a dish that the judges, that includes the feature ingredient for each round. There will be 5 rounds, so 5 dishes cooked by each squad's chef. Now, the first ingredient for today's round is going to be the turkey here, the ground turkey. Now, squads will alternate voting rounds throughout the show. Check the border around your vote options. When it's your squad's color, it's your turn to vote. Vote by clicking right on the screen for your preferred option. You'll have to join a squad first, however, so log into Twitch and click the button in the middle of the screen to get started. Since we have new squads with new names, all squad membership was recently reset completely, so if you didn't join us last Friday, you'll get to choose between our new squads, the Purple Pirate Squad and the Green Ninja Squad. What were you doing behind me there, Echo?
Nothing.
The most votes award a resource to your team chef. Resources include heat sources, cookware, bowls, utensils, and of course ingredients for them to cook with. Your chef can choose to not use these resources, or they can, in any of their dishes. So, let's go ahead and get the first vote started for the Pirate Squad. The first vote is just for items, but soon most voting rounds will include one special option in each choice. Each dish, you will have the opportunity to vote on an ingredient to force on the opposing squad's chef, so they must use that ingredient in the next dish that they serve. You will also be able to sabotage the opposing chef once per dish. Now, sabotages might include stealing resources, distracting the other squad's chef, or restricting their use of resources for a period of time. Now, finally, for each dish, each team will vote on an additional scoring category that will apply for both teams for the next dish to be served. In addition to the scoring categories voted by each squad, every dish will also be judged on taste. Each two judges will rate each dish in 3 scoring categories on a scale from 1 to 10. So 30 points per dish, 30 points per judge, 60 points per dish total, 300 points possible across all 5 dishes. Some of those scoring categories are a little bit vague. They're up to the interpretation of our judges. So let's put 20 minutes on the clock for our first featured ingredient, which is ground turkey again. Now, chefs, are you ready?
I'm ready. I'm gonna win.
And Squad says cook.
Now we gotta do like the Raphael. MMA, like UFC.
Why did you immediately go into fighting? You get to start prepping this ground turkey. Now, as a reminder for the folks at home, you do have to be on a PC or Mac to vote. The technology doesn't yet work on an Android or an Apple phone. So unfortunately, you do have to join on a PC or a Mac. So Raphael, what are you thinking you're gonna do with this ground turkey?
I've never worked with ground turkey before.
You've never worked with ground turkey before.
Do I make a burger? I can make a burger.
You could make a burger. Remember, you gotta make three portions though, two for the judges. And we have our first voting thing coming out here from Trolley Amanda.
Hey,
Amanders, as she told me she wanted to be called.
You get a large bowl for things. And a cast iron skillet. I don't think you have a heat source, so
good luck
with those.
If I eat enough sriracha, I could like breathe fire, right?
You could. You could just breathe fire right into that. Good idea. Let's turn it over to Echo here now. Echo,
heat source.
Yes.
Have you worked with ground turkey?
Oh, lots.
Lots. Okay. Have you really? Is that just something? Okay, I wasn't sure. I can never tell with you if you're just like telling me. So I'm like, oh yeah, lots. I could do that. Awesome.
No, totally.
Well, that sounds good.
So
while these folks are getting started here, let's turn it over to our judges and we'll meet our judges for today. So on the very left there, we have the man, the myth, the legend, his return. Good old Dante, spelled Duante, but pronounced Dante. Dante, how you doing today?
Not too bad, you know.
Awesome.
I'm here. I was almost on time with that Seattle traffic. You know, it's hit or miss.
Okay. And to his left, we have Bernice, a newcomer to the show. Hi, Bernice. How you doing?
Doing great. You told me to be hungry, so I'm starving right now.
Awesome. Thank you. Well, we'll come back to you in just a moment here. Mm-hmm. We're about to give a couple extra ingredients here over to Green Squad, it looks like.
You're blessed with avocado oil. You're welcome.
I'm very excited.
I mean, squad say you're welcome. And then you get a glass bowl and this pan with a lid. So
fantastic.
It's a saucepan, Amanders.
Yes, it is. Correct.
No heat yet?
No
heat yet?
No. Not yet. You don't get
I have oil. I'm very happy. All right.
Whoop, vote for me.
So I'm getting in my ear production saying that. You're supposed to have the super pot and a panini press. So, Amanders, if you wouldn't mind bringing the panini press and the super pot that I put away because nobody told me they were supposed to be for them.
Super pot?
Okay, so let's
Details.
See here. Details. It's fine. We'll get them back out here.
Thank you.
Both of you guys should have a paring knife as well.
Yes.
So you are able to use those right away, right now. So
well,
if you do want to use those, Raphael, if you want to cut those burgers up with the paring knife, go right ahead.
I'm turning into patties right now.
Oh, perfect. So, Raphael, you've never worked with ground turkey before.
Nope.
But you're still planning. Yep, go ahead and give him the toss in the panini
press.
There you go. But you're still planning on making a burger with that.
Yes.
So, do you know how to cook just like a regular beef burger?
And, sure.
Okay, so.
I can put
but this
on a
is
grill,
turkey.
Except I don't have a grill.
Well, you have a panini press.
I got a panini press.
Yeah, so go ahead. You can plug that guy in there if you want to there. You have some plugs right off to the side there. If you'd like to get started on that. Same for you, Echo. Go ahead and cook your ground turkey right inside of that super pot.
I'm gonna do that.
All right, sounds good, everybody. So,
I just need some seasonings.
Some seasonings is what you're saying you could use from
yes,
the Green
please.
Squad. All right, so let's turn it back over to the judges real quick here if we could for just a moment. We didn't get the chance to actually talk to them. Dante, tell us a little bit about yourself here real quick in between the ingredients being delivered.
I'm actually a comedian and a father of four girls. I do comedy downtown Seattle, Tacoma, all the way up to Bellingham. I'm actually going to be going down to Portland next weekend.
Yeah.
Stretch my area, if you know what I mean. You can find me on Twitter. It's Dante, the T is silent, so it's Dwayne with a T, 17 on Twitter. Other than that, just trying to enjoy the holidays and hopefully get some food. I'm starving like Bernice.
Awesome. And then we'll go back to Bernice in just a second here. Amanda, why don't you tell us what Purple Squad got here?
You have garbanzo beans, jalapenos, and a blender to go along with those.
Oh, geez.
Maybe to blend them.
Here's that can opener for those garbanzo beans
Thank
as well.
You.
Also that. Good luck with that.
Also that.
Also that.
That's my
like. Season.
That is my favorite. So let's also turn it back over to the judges here so we can also meet Bernice. Bernice, tell us a little bit about you, who you are, where we can find you, what you do.
Cool. I am a stand-up comedian as well. And outside that, I'm a dancer and also a writer at the Syndrome magazine. I also have a daytime job, so only trying to find time to do stand-up comedy. What else do you want to know?
That's all. That's all we need to know, if that's all you want us to know. Perfect. So, Echo, you are not really doing all that much with your turkey here. Now, we got 15 minutes and 14 seconds left on the clock. What are you planning on doing with this ground turkey?
I would like to give it some flavor.
Okay.
Turkey is a very mild meat.
I mean, I like it. On its own.
Yeah, but you didn't know what corn looks like, dear.
I didn't know what it looked like in the husk, all right? Or in the thing, in the wrapper that it comes in, right? So, what are you gonna do with it, though?
I'm hoping for some kind of seasonings to do with it, and then maybe like a little mini meatloaf.
Oh, okay, a meatloaf. Okay, what are things that you could use in a meatloaf? Breadcrumbs, maybe?
Breadcrumbs, any kind of like herbs. Tomato, maybe ketchup, you know, some kind of saucy thing.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens.
Awesome.
Help me out.
Here's Amanda's bringing some more ingredients over.
Ooh. Here for you, I have not breadcrumbs. These are bonito flakes.
Bonito flakes, okay.
So they're fish and probably pretty gross.
Some delicious.
Seasoning, pink salt. So they're all, it's all a color theme here is what's going on, very pink.
Cool. Thank you.
Ooh, I can work with this. What was the forced ingredient there, Amanda's, if you don't?
Oh,
you
know,
at the top here. She's going to go find out for me.
Oh, while one is force.
Oh, the bonito flakes
were force. Of course.
However, I do want to say here real quick, whoever pulled the ingredients, these are ground shrimp. These are so ground shrimp it is. Raphael, let's turn it over to you as well. So what are you doing in your pot here? I don't know if we could get a good overhead shot of what you've got going on.
I don't really have
Thank you for turning the bowl for that. That's good.
And so basically what I got is a little bit of jalapenos to add a little bit of flavor to the patties, other than just cooking them straight up.
Yeah.
And so I figured because they got a little bit of saltiness and sourness to it, it would add to the turkey flavor.
Yeah.
That sounds great.
Now you're aware that in just a second here. Amanda's is about to bring out some ingredients, and one of those will be forced upon you, which might change that whole plan that you have.
Yeah, that's why I haven't started mixing these just
yet. Okay, good. That's smart. No, that's great. You've obviously been on this show before.
Oh, you know, I'm hoping that gives me an advantage, but we'll see.
You might end up microwaving the turkey like
last time. Yeah, if I can get the microwave, guys, oh man, we'll be set.
That might not be a good thing. I don't know if that's going to be a good thing. So, plan thus far, something that'll go along with those, with the meatballs. There's some seasonings I heard you had mentioned along with Echo there. It looks like you're both in desperate need of that. Now we only have 12 minutes and 51 seconds left, but seasonings is on the top of your list right now.
Yes, and I gotta squeeze the flavor out.
Remember, you only have to do 3 platings right now. So don't worry about making 5 of them. Oh, and what do you got for us, Amanda?
You're lucky with the seasonings. You got some spiced garlic, chili pepper, salt, and forced smoked oysters. So we have a seafood thing going on. All right, have fun.
What a reaction,
Turkey burger is my oyster.
Okay, so let's ask our judges here, because those are two super odd forced ingredients. We have the ground shrimp on this side, and then we also have the smoked oysters on this side here. Can we go over to our judges and see what they think about those two forced ingredients, how they think they're gonna be thrown into those turkey, here?
No. So I see she's making a meatball.
Yeah.
So I think she's gonna sprinkle a little shrimp on the top to give it a little flavor or something like that.
Mixed it in.
Oh no, please don't. And then the other guy, I was hoping he'd fry up the oyster. He's gonna do that burger, give it a little texture.
Yeah. Ooh, fry the oysters up. Ooh, now Bernice, what about you? How do you feel about those?
Well, so I am Chinese, so I grew up eating all kinds of weird shit. And, you know, dry shrimp actually is a pretty typical ingredient, so I'm not too afraid of it.
Yeah.
I always think turkey is a very tasteless bird. The smoked oyster, though, I'm very concerned.
Gotcha. That's a tough ingredient to work with there.
It's only
He might have gotten a good... gotten lucky there with that sea salt, but man, did he get unlucky with those smoked oysters there. Purple Squad did not give him a good, easy thing to work with there. What do you do? So you got the salt. What is your plan for those smoked oysters, if you don't mind me asking there, Raphael?
I figured they'd go with the jalapenos, and then you'd taste more of the jalapenos than the oyster.
Okay.
I have to use it, right?
You got some advice from the chefs looking maybe to fry those up. If you get a heat source, maybe try that out. Maybe even pop those guys on the panini press and go for it. Mm. Ooh, Amanda, what do you got for us here?
You have Frank's Red Hot.
Okay.
Mayonnaise. Maybe cool that down a little or not. And the sabotage is that Purple Squad has to serve their dishes in mugs.
Oh, you got mugs.
Which is your specialty.
I got mugs. I love it.
All right, so Amanda, you want to bring out those next time you come back out? Those guys are right next to us over here, ooh, the mugs. Ooh, so you're going to have to end up plating in mugs. Now, yeah. Echo, do you think that's going to benefit you guys at all or nothing thus far? How have you seen it in the past work out?
As far as sabotages go, it's kind of a nice one. It's like, okay, I'll take pity on you. You can use a mug. And especially Mr. Microwave over there.
Like, Mr. Microwave. I love that nickname. Just like Man of a Million Microwaves.
Proud of it.
He's always using mugs in the microwave.
Wait a minute. Proud of it. You microwaved beef with some like stew meat in there last time.
God.
It was an incredible feat. But, okay, so now you've ignored the idea of putting the oysters in that grill. You're gonna just throw those panini
into the meat.
The oysters?
Yep.
I did not see those go in there. Have you really put that much in there? Is it gonna be a fully realized thing?
Not really. I don't know how much people like oysters, but.
I'm trying to lead you. I'm trying to get you to go. You know what, they're not bad. I had them last time.
Really?
Have you tasted it yet?
Not yet.
You might wanna taste it. Uh-oh, what happened? Echo had an accident over here.
I'm just so nervous.
They don't smell so good.
They smell great, I feel like. Hold on a second. They're fine.
Would you like to eat some?
I mean, no. No? I don't think so. We got another sabotage that's getting ready to come out here.
Oh, no.
Yep, Purple Squad's voting on a good sabotage for you. Uh-oh, and Amanda's has not an idea of where it's at here. Perfect.
No.
Thank you, Amanda.
You were gifted the right front burner.
Oh.
Oh.
You get the right front burner.
And the sabotage is double trouble.
Double trouble. Okay, that
means.
Thank you. No, I appreciate that. I guess there was no slip over there. Echo, now double trouble, what that means is that you're going to have to plate twice as many servings this time.
No problem.
So you've got to plate six instead of four, and they get to pick the three that go in.
That's fine, because all going to be beautiful.
They're all going to be beautiful. You hear that, judges? Are you excited about that? Mm-hmm. No, Duante's shaking his head. Let's turn it over to Duante, and we'll turn it over to Bernice and see what they're thinking here, because these two sabotages, they're not the worst thus far, but they could trip them up. We got plating in mugs for the Purple Squad, and we've got the plating six servings on the Green Squad. What are you two thinking about that?
I'm thinking Echo's the mom, because she said all her meatballs are beautiful. That's a mom thing to
say. She is a mom.
Right?
How did you know?
Exactly. I could just tell. Like, all my kids are special. That's
They're just all beautiful. I love them all dearly.
One of them looks like the dad. No, I'm just joking. I'm glad she laughed at that. I'm excited, though. She's made an aioli out of the oil, the hot sauce, and the mayonnaise. I'm paying attention here. That's going to give it a little kick for me, you know. I like the little heat with my food, so I'm excited.
Awesome. And Bernice, how are you feeling about these sabotages? We got plating in mugs. In six different servings, the opposing team gets to choose which ones get served to y'all.
I like Echo's confidence.
Yeah.
Like, you know, she's like, got it. I believe in her, you know. About the mug, I think I'm already not looking forward to oyster in turkey.
Yeah.
Like, I don't like any of the ingredients. The mug does not look any better.
No, absolutely.
Yeah, I think Fluff, you have to pull up some magic.
Gotcha. So, Insta-Fluff, you're going to have to pull up some magic here. Here we go. We got Trolley Amanda back again.
Gifted to the Green Squad was the left front burner.
Yes.
And the scoring category for both teams is bite size.
Ooh, okay, so it's both teams bite size. Judges, bite size is the first scoring category. We want to remind everyone at home that bite size is only two of three scoring categories, and it's going to be worth 10 points out of the 30 points. All right, and so let's go ahead and see what we got here. Echo, that's looking pretty darn good over there.
Why, thank you.
Yeah, you're welcome. Now, okay, well, you got a little sizzle going on as well, but I mean, that's for show, I guess. It's to get their senses going. For the drama.
If only you could smell this at home.
Insta-Fluff, let's see what you've got going on over here. Wow, already plating in your mugs there. Now, you've got three going thus far. Are you going to cook those other two up or not at all?
I am. I might as well, because I'm kind of hungry.
You're kind of hungry. Do those have oysters in them or not?
Nope, not these.
Okay, so you're just cooking those two with no oysters in
them. But I actually did try some. It's actually not bad.
See, that's what I mean. Yeah. They're actually good. Here's what I probably would have maybe thought you would have done was maybe chop those guys up and then mix them into the... Is that what you did?
I
mixed them with the
jalapenos.
And then put them in and mixed it with the batter. A little bit.
Jalapenos mixed with the oysters. Dante's shaking his head no.
I swear, they actually taste pretty good.
Dante,
pleasantly surprised.
What did you need, bowls? Oh, we got bowls right over here. Let's see.
Six of them?
Yep, here, let me get you. Here's three out of the six.
Thank you.
Boy, what a terrible sabotage that you now have to split your burgers in half and plate six of them with the aioli sauce. Now, we've got another scoring category on its way out here in just a moment, and we'll announce that for you judges here as well and go over to you in just a moment here.
So, InstaFluff, over here we have honey for you.
Oh, boy.
And another really heavy cast iron skillet. So now you have two.
Thank you for all these skills.
Well, good job, Purple Squad.
And your scoring category is going to be aroma.
Aroma, got it.
You know what they say about turkey.
Aroma.
The very aromatic meat.
Yeah, especially with the oysters.
Ooh. Judges, so let's go to you for about those scoring categories. We've got aromatic is the last scoring category there. And then we also had bite size was the other one. So this might turn out all right here for both squads. What are you two thinking? Dante, if you want to go first here.
I'm thinking he got a key ingredient.
Yeah.
Key ingredient, if he knows how to do it with that honey. But I don't think he's giving it any attention.
Ooh, okay.
And then the whole bite size thing is really favoring that double trouble.
It is.
Kind of made it obsolete, like the good mom. She had to make lunch for kindergartners instead of middle schoolers, so she just split lunches in half and called it a day.
Yeah. Bernice, how you feeling about scoring categories of aroma and also bite size?
Okay, so aroma, maybe both. The food is smelling good. I just don't know which person is that.
Yeah. It's maybe both.
Yeah, so I think it's hopeful. And then once we added the honey, maybe it's going to be better. I like to have a little salty and a sweet thing happening.
It's classic, classic flavor combination.
Right, yeah. Bite size, I think it's just a little cop out, right? You just cut it in half, cut it in thirds.
Bite size. It's an easy one to do.
Easy.
All right, now we've only got about 3 minutes left here on the clock, Chef, so start getting ready here, although it looks like you're way ahead of me, both of y'all, getting these nice and chopped up. Echo chopping these up real small. Amanda's with another ingredient for us. What do you got for us?
Hey, Green Squad.
Hello.
I think your squad blessed you with so many different flavors here. Ooh. You have a curry cube.
Oh.
I've never seen a cube of curry, but there it is.
Yes.
Sesame oil and chicken broth.
I can't wait to see what you make. Thank you. Oh, I'm so excited about those curry cubes.
About the curry cubes specifically. Echo, why are you excited about those? Or is that going to be used on a later thing, maybe?
That's going to be used in the in a later dish.
Ooh.
Yes.
All right. How do you know what those later dishes are, Echo?
Because it's sitting right here.
What is it that you're doing right now? Just chopping things up, getting things to cook through all the way, it looks like?
Yep, just making sure that I'm not serving raw meat, because nobody wants that.
I mean, raw turkey is my favorite way to have turkey
That's
meatballs.
That's because you're a beast.
Oh, thank you.
Yeah.
I don't know if this must be a bad thing or not. InstaFluff, you got the honey going in here. You're using a lot of that honey on that turkey. Maybe a drizzle would have been better?
I figured it'd be more like a honey, instead of a honey glazed turkey, this would be more like a honey soaked turkey.
Oh, okay, honey soaked turkey. So you're hoping that maybe the power of that honey will overpower the flavor of that oyster, maybe.
Yeah, the problem with the panini press is that it makes them really dry.
Yeah, it cooks it real fast. It's because it's really hot heat.
Yeah.
If only you had an oil, but you don't.
You do actually have the oil that's inside of those sliced jalapenos. You realize that, right? There we go. That was my advice for you. That might be olive oil that's in there. So, chefs, you have 1 minute and 10 seconds left here. Get ready. And remember, when that countdown is done, you're delivering those over to the judges yourself today. So, how are those smelling over there?
Gotta smell it. Aroma is one of
the categories. I just turn around and he's smelling his just in case. Okay, I don't know if spice salt will add much aroma, but you're going for it anyway.
Yeah, it's got to counterbalance the sweetness a little bit, right?
Gotcha. No, that makes sense. I understand completely. Now, folks, we've only got about 43 seconds left on the clock. Here, these two are getting ready. Wow, are you ready to take yours over already?
I think so, we got it.
Okay, and then we've got about 30 seconds left. Echo putting finishing touches on hers. Now, Echo, what are you doing here?
I figure for a little extra aroma, I'm gonna go ahead and sprinkle these little dried shrimpies.
Oh, okay.
On the outside, give it a little flair.
Yeah, you know? A little flair. That's what I'd call it.
Yep. I'm doing my best.
It's pretty
here.
Strong. Are you sure that ingredient's gonna come out all right there, even if it's just placed on the side?
Oh, yeah.
It was actually in the dish, correct?
Yes, I put about, I don't know, like a tablespoon, maybe yeah. two, in the meat itself.
All right, judges, and that, or chefs, and that is time. Go ahead and take.
All right.
Rafael, if you want to pick the three that you'd like us to serve here, the Green Squad to serve, go ahead and we'll take that over.
Which three?
Oh. Say this one, mm-hmm. that one, and that one.
Okay. Perfect. So go ahead over to the judges, and they will determine the scores for your dishes.
Hello. These are bite-sized sweet honey turkey burgers for you.
Mm-hmm. Thank you.
Hope you enjoy. Bon appetit.
Thank you.
So I have here a tiny turkey bite that will kick your butt, but gently.
Thank you.
With a nice aroma of shrimp and spicy things. Enjoy.
Oh, thank you.
We got the ingredient cart here.
Oh,
go ahead.
Woo. God, the snow.
All right, so I've already put theirs here. I'll take that and I'll go place this right over here real quick.
Oh, the dry shrimp in the air.
That's a good idea.
All right, and so we, go ahead, Amanda, go ahead and put that over there.
Your next featured ingredient is breakfast sausage.
Woo!
Yum, I actually like this. And Purple Squad is gifted sherry.
Yes.
Go right
plastic
ahead.
Plastic spoon.
Got some liquids.
And then mayonnaise as well.
Perfect. Wow. All right. Now this the time has already started on this next one, so go right ahead and go right into it, chefs. You've got everything that you had at your disposal from the previous round, so keep that going. Dante's looking pretty satisfied over there. We're going to find out pretty soon here exactly what they thought of those dishes while you two are cooking here. Now, Echo, since since he's washing over there, what do you think about this breakfast sausage? Breakfast sausage is a pretty easy thing. I mean, what? It's already seasoned, probably.
Yeah, it's not seasoning, so I'm kind of just waiting to see what the categories are.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
What I can possibly dress it up with.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
So just more ingredients coming down the pipeline there, and then just seeing. I mean, you got a little bit of hot sauce and whatnot on there. And then let's turn it over to InstaFluff. InstaFluff, you're already starting on the pork shoulder. Now the pork shoulder is the last one.
Yes.
It's gonna be the fifth one, but you're starting on it now.
I wanted to have it seasoned a little bit, and so.
Okay.
Now that I got the sherry, I wanted to soak it a little bit in there while I prep the sausages.
That's a great idea. So the cooking sherry, what is that gonna do to your pork shoulder there?
I think it'll actually tenderize it a little bit and give it a little bit more flavor than just like raw beef.
That's awesome to hear. So what about the breakfast sausage? Where are you going with that thus far? Now you do have this,
sausage,
and I believe you have one of those burners. You have the front burner.
I do like the panini press and how the turkey turned out. And so I think I'm gonna go with that, this plan here, except this time it won't have to be bite-sized, right?
Yeah.
Unless you guys vote for it.
Unless they vote for bite-size again.
And so we'll see.
Yeah, no, absolutely. So ingredients will start coming out here in just a moment there. Now, Echo, you're turning those into little, what looks like little mini sausages or strips?
Something like that.
Oh, Amanda's is here.
Your squad gifted you with canned coconut milk.
Sweet.
Might go nice with the curry.
Yes,
I don't know, just a suggestion. Baking powder.
Woo. We'll do something with it. I'm
That's
excited.
That's some fanfare.
All right, and your forced ingredient is gonna be cream of mushroom soup.
Oh, darn. Oh, no, whatever will I do? Cream of mushroom soup.
That's a really, okay, now I have to say, that's a really versatile ingredient
that
you can use there. That's awesome.
I'm excited.
I mean, cream of mushroom goes with a lot of different things. I think that could go great with that breakfast sausage.
Yeah, I'm actually going to change my mind up a little bit here.
Are you really? So you're going to change things? Now that you've gotten that force ingredient, it's going to change that pathway that you're going down.
Yes.
Awesome. Any ideas thus far that you want to share? You don't have to share yet.
I'm not going to share yet.
All right, that's fine.
But I have a plan.
Keep your secrets.
I'm going
to. We'll go ahead and turn it over to InstaFluff. InstaFluff, now you've seasoned that breakfast sausage with some of your spiced sea salt. Can you use any of the honey in that or the mayonnaise?
Oh, not this time.
Not this time. Gotcha.
After it's done, maybe.
Maybe.
I'd like to see what comes out.
Okay, awesome. No, that sounds good. You're going to be getting a fourth ingredient here pretty quick, I believe. Yeah. So
this time I'm going for presentation. So instead of having the rounded burgers mm-hmm. like everyone usually serves or like the sausages, this is going to be like rectangular shape.
You're all cool. about thinking outside of the box.
Oh, yeah.
You've absolutely
outside
got
outside the mug, outside everything.
And folks, if this
inside
is your
the kitchen, though.
What's that? Inside the kitchen? Ooh, actually, sorry about that, Echo. I just got from the production team here saying that was a green vote. So the fourth ingredient of the mushroom goes to the other squad, unfortunately.
No, it's too late. You already gave it to me.
After
it's
you
mine.
Changed, nope, too late here. It's forced
mine.
On the other squad. That's already after you changed what you were doing, isn't it?
It's not a huge difference, really,
okay.
So.
Okay, so not a big deal.
No.
We do want to say at home also, if this is your first time joining us or you're just rejoining us after our break there, if you weren't here on Friday, the squads have been reset. So you are free to join either the green squad, which is the green, stop that, the green ninjas. Okay, do that. It's fine. You can hype them up. Or you could join the purple squad, which is the purple pirates.
Purple pirates.
See, look how stoked he is
Arr.
On that.
Do I have a heat source?
Do you have a heat source? You have the front burner.
That's what I thought.
Yeah, I was going to say, your squad gave you that front right burner. And we're just waiting on that next force ingredient vote to come on through. We'll find out what green squad is going to have to deal with here in just a second.
Okay.
Ooh, now you've also got that curry cube going on.
Yes, I do.
What are you going to do with that?
I'm going to start on the pork shoulder.
That sounds good. All right, so I'm going to turn it over to the judges here real quick. I'm heading right over to there to find out some of the scores on them. Let's go over to here. All right. Judges, how's it going?
Doing well.
What was that? What was that for? Dante? So,
you know, there's a difference in palates between me and Bernice.
Yeah.
And I feel like the last little thing she Echo did for her dish mm-hmm. negatively affected my rating.
Gotcha. Okay.
And then for me at least, I liked what he did with the honey and the flakes, so it made my judging a little better. I think he won my round.
Gotcha.
Whereas her palate's a little different, so I think it went the other way.
Bernice, how did you feel about the dishes?
Yeah. So the wet turkey in a mug, mm-hmm. I mean, Dante, I don't know, because you didn't eat much. Like, your mug is full. but it was a little hard, because like I think that the liquid at the bottom is also feels like there's a honey soup at the bottom to
okay.
me, so that was hard to eat. But I think the sauce on Echo's little meatball, it's quite a nice touch. So yeah, it's nice that we have different opinions.
I just didn't get past the shrimp. I'm not a that shrimp taste and
not
aroma
shrimp,
that no. just killed me.
So. Gotcha. Mm-hmm. Well, let's go ahead. That is very strong. Let's see what the scores were there. We're going to get those from the production team in just a second here. I'll be able to announce who was the winner of round one. So it looks like here the scores were purple squad 36, green squad 40 points. So currently green squad is in the lead, the ninja squad, and it came out pretty evenly. What was the 2-point penalty there for Bernice?
I just didn't see any like the oyster.
Okay.
And then I don't taste it.
Absolutely.
I think, you know, that makes the challenge hard. I feel like maybe like by adding just tiny little bit, it's kind of a cheating.
It would have been, you wanted it more realized in the dish.
Yeah, exactly.
Awesome. Well, thank you, you two. We'll get to you in just a little bit here. Let's go back and turn it over to our chefs. So let's get that voting going again. There we can see for the next forced ingredient. You didn't get your forced ingredient until late in this round, unfortunately.
Uh-huh.
Wow,
it's gonna be an adventure.
That is gonna be a real big disadvantage on your part there. Who knows what you could get? You could get, I don't know. I don't know what's a terrible ingredient that's gonna come with that.
It doesn't matter, because I'm gonna make it work.
That's fine. Sounds good, Echo. See, she's very confident. That's why you came.
You like the smoked oysters?
Actually, I think they're very tasty.
Look at how like willing you are to share. Wait a minute, Echo, did you say those are tasty?
Smoked oysters? Yeah.
I'll have to try them.
Really, they're a nice snack.
All right, hold on, let's see.
Go ahead, Ted eats. Count one.
Is it in olive oil or?
Well, read the can.
I don't know. That's a really big one. I don't want that. You want that while we're waiting for this next one? All right, it's fine. You can have those back. Nobody wants those except for you. So what have you got going on? You've got that breakfast sausage being done, cooking in the panini press. You've totally forgotten the fact that you have a front right burner.
Yes, I want to save those for the beef.
Okay.
So
you think that you won't be able to, or are you just saving these for that? That way you don't have to clean them again.
Oh, I would really nice, like to have the space.
There we go. Now you have two. Now you actually have a cutting board as well.
Oh!
Echo, what you got going on in the stove?
I am preparing the curry cubes.
You're prepping the curry cubes?
Yes.
So how do you prep a curry cube? Because I've never used a curry cube in anything before.
It's got like an oily base to it, mm-hmm. so it'll melt, and then you can add more liquid to it, and it just creates this beautiful curry broth that's very flavorful.
That sounds tasty. That's awesome. All right, now we've got forced ingredient coming out here for you, Echo, so
that's
we'll find out what they've thrown at you.
Bring
we've
it.
Got some ingredients for Raphael about to find their way out here on Trolley-O-Manders' trolley.
Oh, no.
She comes out. Uh-oh. All right, Echo, you ready for this?
I'm ready. I was born ready.
What do we got, Amanda?
All right, Purple Squad, you got two things that go really well together. Pizza crust and a hand mixer.
Oh, thank you.
I know you love those. Oh. And I'm so sorry about the mushroom soup mix-up. I blame Ted. But your actual forced ingredient is going to be tiger blood syrup.
Okay.
Interesting.
Have fun. Thanks.
Ooh. Now, tiger blood syrup. Echo, I don't know if you know too much about the tiger blood syrup.
I've heard the legend.
So the tiger blood syrup is made from real tigers. That's actually not true. It's just syrup that you put on top of snow cones.
Okay.
So, and it is sort of like a cherry.
Great.
Or a strawberry. So good luck with that. Any thoughts off the bat of what you're gonna do with that? Do you have a chicken broth you could mix that with? I don't know if that'd go with anything.
Oh, it has to be this dish.
It has to be this dish. You got 10 minutes to figure that out too.
I got it. I have the tiger.
You got it.
I got it.
You're kidding me. Wow. All right.
I'm just that good.
And then, have you gotten your force ingredient? It's a cream of mushroom.
Yep.
We didn't ask you. What are you going to do with this?
I'm actually going to put it as a sauce, like kind of like gravy on top of the sausages. I figured
you're going to do it on top of that. Actually, might turn out really good. Are you going to do that? Like, are you going to heat that up at all?
I was trying to, but I'm trying to figure out how I can heat this.
You
up.
Do have a pan right over there. Are you thinking of just putting it on cold cream of mushroom? What are you looking for,
can
Echo?
Opener.
I don't know quite yet. It would be really nice to get a pot or something.
There you go. You each got a can opener
okay.
this time around.
Oh,
we're doing more
share.
Than one, everybody. All right, so judges, we want to turn it over to you real quick. Now, the featured ingredient here is breakfast sausage. This is a pretty... Good.
Why?
Nice shot, Echo. Good job. That was solid stuff. Judges, let's turn it over to you. Breakfast sausage. Are you both breakfast people at all? Do you like breakfast sausage? Is it something you have on the reg? Is this a delicious, good ingredient? I don't know. Let's start with Bernice this time. I've been going to Dante a bunch.
Mm.
What are you thinking?
I am totally a breakfast person.
Yeah?
I like breakfast sausage, and I feel like, you know, there's a lot of things you can make out of it, and
absolutely.
It's the flavor, so I have high hope for this one.
Absolutely. Dante, how you feeling?
I like to make homemade biscuits and gravy with sausage gravy.
Sounds
it's
really
one of
good.
One the easiest things to do.
I know, but it's really good, regardless.
It's really fattening, too. So
yeah, it is.
I love it. So now you're kind of in a predicament, because you're with an ingredient I care about, so this is going to be I'm not trusting that sauce either. I see how you looked at her.
Oh, we'll find out here. Thank you. Amanda, what do you got for us here?
All right. You got some orange mini peppers.
Thank you, thank you.
I don't know if those are spicy or sweet, but I just think peppers are gross. And... But, I mean, you might make them taste good.
But
I don't know.
I don't like them. You might.
And you have a medium pan. I don't know if you need this, but in case you don't want
just
the small pan, you have another.
Great, thank you.
And Purple
thank
Squad is gonna have to cook with one arm for, I think, 5 minutes.
Ooh, yeah.
One
that's
arm
a
bandit.
One arm with 5 minutes. So of the 7 minutes and 50 seconds left, you have 5 minutes. Let's put those on the clock there.
It's no problem, I'm a pirate.
Ooh, something smells very sweet. Is that the curry that I'm smelling coming
probably.
From?
Probably.
Hold on a second, I gotta turn over here. Let's get an overhead of that curry there while I sniff it, just so we could get a good shot of that. I'm really curious
probably
about this
stir
here.
It.
That actually does smell really good. So that is what I'm smelling there. That's going to be really, really good. That cream of mushroom there, I got to agree. I think the cream of mushroom, that fourth ingredient, is going to go very nicely with that. Assuming, again, you can heat that up because
the
congealed
stole.
The ingredient that he deserved. But congealed cream of mushroom, I don't know. You're going to heat it up in that guy?
Yep.
All right, there we go.
But I wanted to wait until a little bit because it's otherwise it's going to cool for a while.
Yeah.
And so we'll see.
You don't want it congealing.
Yeah.
Oh, Amanda's back already with more ingredients and more sabotages.
All right, we got a fish theme going on. Fish sauce for you.
Do I have to use this?
You don't have
to.
No.
Oh, okay.
You've got some hot sauce.
Do I have to use this?
No.
And the sabotage is that you get to put a tablespoon of sugar into whatever green squad dish you want, but
with one hand.
You
can't do that with one arm.
One arm.
One tablespoon?
One tablespoon is what it said.
That's a TBSP. Got it.
There we go.
Got this.
All right, let's see how he does this because this is incredible. Oh, they're saying they want me to help you, so. He's got it. I thought it was funnier the other way.
Ah.
I don't know what everyone's in the back's getting all mad at me about. Ooh, that is a lot of brown sugar. Wow. All right, enjoy. What is he gonna put that in? Wow, doing it early. And here's the
thing.
I don't think that was a bad thing on Echo or for the green squad here.
Oh, really?
No, not at all. That pork probably might benefit from that brown sugar.
It's gonna
You're
be
welcome.
Delicious.
So there you go, Purple Squad.
Yeah.
Judges, let's head over to here with those sabotages there. So you have one sabotage that was armed behind the back. It doesn't look like that's, I mean, he's still cooking. But then the second one, which is the one that I want to focus on here, was the brown sugar on the pork shoulder.
Oh.
It's not too bad, is it? Why are you shaking your head? One of you is nodding yes.
I want to coach him, you know? I just like, why didn't you ruin the damn fucking curry? Brown sugar and curry is not that. Come on, work with me, Stifluff. You're wearing my alma mater color.
Mean.
I was rooting purple. You're making us look bad. Come on, buddy.
And then, Bernice, how do you feel about that? Brown sugar on the pork, it seems like it's going to come out okay.
I think there's great opportunities to make that great. Like, you're pre-marinating the pork a little bit, but I think a little sweetness in pork, if you have enough savory or spicy going on, it's really nice.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, thank you to both of you here. We'll turn back to you in a second. Amanda is out here with some more ingredients and a scoring category.
So the Green Squad has given Echo a slotted spatula.
Yay! I really needed this.
And a head of cauliflower.
Ooh, she really needed this.
I also needed veggies, yes.
And your guys' scoring category for this round is for company.
For company.
For company. So judges, for company. Ooh. No, not the number four, for company. as if you were making it for company. Or however you want to decide, that's totally fine as well. So Echo.
Yes.
So Echo, you got cauliflower here.
Yep.
Are you gonna be using that in this dish? Are you thinking, with only 4 minutes left, are you gonna wait for the next dish?
I'm not using that in this dish.
Okay,
but
sounds good.
I will be using it, so thank you everybody.
Yeah, great job there to the Green Squad. Now, is your dish almost finished here? You've got the pork, you've got some peppers in there.
Yep.
You're gonna have some curry to go along with that. That sounds like it's gonna come out all right.
I think I'm gonna be good.
Can I ask what's happening with this?
It's a thing that's happening right now.
All right.
And I'm gonna have to make it work.
So you don't exactly know exactly what's gonna happen with it?
No, I have a plan.
Okay.
I'll do my best.
Cool, sounds good. Let's say here, folks, if this is your first time watching, we do wanna ask you to follow us here if you're enjoying what you're seeing or subscribing. If you haven't joined a squad, please do click on that screen. It says play for free there. You can play and join us for free. All you have to do is click on the button in the middle and join either the Green Squad or the Purple Squad there. Amanda, she's got more ingredients coming out here with scoring category. Real good one here.
All right, Purple Squad. Apparently, your team wants you to have only spicy things. You got chili negro.
It's getting hot in here.
And we got hot paprika. And the scoring category for both of you guys is going to be salty, along with for company.
You guys are amazing.
So salty. Salty there, judges. Now, judges, Ooh, the one-armed bandit stun. You're good to go.
Oh, thank you.
Yep, absolutely. Now let's turn it back over to our judges. We're going to discuss the two scoring categories. Scatting categories.
No, thank you.
Of salty and whatever that other scoring category was there.
For company.
Oh, and for company.
Classic.
I'm going to forget every single one of them there. So, judges, what are you thinking about those? What do those mean to you there? With 2 minutes, 15 seconds on the clock, give us a brief description there. Bernice, what are you thinking?
What does salty mean? Like, is it like I define it?
You
like,
define
at
it.
At the right level of saltiness?
You can define that however you want.
All right, I like that. It's easy.
Yeah.
It's easy for me to assess that. For coupling, I just imagine, like, you know, if I would eat that with any of them together, right?
Yeah.
Like, okay, yeah. This is easy. I think this two are pretty easy.
Pretty easy?
Mm-hmm.
All right there. Dante, how are you feeling about
for
that?
For company, I'm looking for presentation.
Presentation, okay.
And then for salty, there's a thin line between salty and hate.
Yeah. No, I get it. So both of you are sort of interpreting it as the proper level of salt is salty.
Yeah.
That's great. Awesome. Those are some pretty well-defined scoring categories. I think those shouldn't be too difficult to hit here. InstaFluff, you got 2 minutes, or you got a minute and 30 seconds left.
Where
How's
can
it coming? Oh, your dishes? Your dishes are in the front here.
Oh.
Yeah, go ahead and grab whatever you need there.
I'm
same for you there, Echo, whatever you need to grab. Go ahead and grab those.
Oh, I'm kind of regretting putting the sugar on the beef now.
Yeah, see, on the beef? You said it was pork.
Oh, wait,
or
we only have to do three this
time. Yeah.
Yep, you only got to do three. It's pork. Here comes Amanda with another ingredient here with 1 minute left on the clock, everybody. Amanda, what do you got for us real quick here?
Echo, I just want to say I think you should love your squad.
I do.
Because they are giving you so many good spices right now.
Yes!
They gave you oregano.
Ooh.
Coriander.
Ooh.
Ooh, coriander.
Ooh.
And arbol chili.
Oh my god, thank you.
Great job.
They're so nice.
I kind of want
thank
I
you,
wish
Green
I
Squad.
Had a little bit earlier, but I can still totally make that work.
Great job there, Green Squad.
Thank
Sounds
you.
Like Echo is pretty pumped on what you're giving her there. Keep doing that. We've only got about 30 seconds left on the clock here. Both chefs plating. InstaFluff, what's going on with your dish here?
All right.
Oh, wow. Here he's got 30 seconds left. He's getting that mushroom sauce right on top of there, that cream of mushroom. That was a forced ingredient for him. Looks like it's turning out A-OK. And then let's go ahead and turn it over to Echo here. Echo, you're just scooping it up. You got 12 seconds. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, four, three, two, one, and you guys should be finished cooking. Go ahead and take those dishes over to the judges.
All right.
So I present to you my breakfast sausage curry dish with some sweet pepper on top. And I would like to, for your consideration in terms of saltiness, that freaking cream of mushroom was not a sabotage, okay? I'm gonna be salty right now. That was garbage. Oh, I'm sorry, did you want to get in here?
Yes, please.
where's our tiger syrup?
Oh, I put a spoonful of the tiger sauce that I made in the dish.
Mm.
Yes.
Okay.
And judges, I present to you gravy with breakfast sausage.
Thank you.
These are cream of mushroom gravy right on top of a gourmet breakfast sausage. I hope you guys enjoy.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, and we'll turn it back over to here. While the judges are judging that, eating their food, we're gonna put another 20 minutes on the clock and get another voting round started. The next featured ingredient for both of you all are gonna be these corn tortillas. Now, corn tortillas for both of you there. So let's get the time going, and they are voting already on the next ingredient. Now, let's see, InstaFluff, corn tortillas, how do you feel about that? Are you good? Do you cook with, like, Mexican things ever? Or is this a new experience?
We'll see. I like flour tortillas.
Yeah.
I know corn tortillas tend to rip really easily, so I got to be pretty careful with it.
Here's also I want to bring some attention to. You saved some of that turkey meat. Maybe that turkey meat might go into this one. I don't know.
Yeah. I was thinking either that or the breakfast sausage.
Yeah.
It really depends, because I still left a little bit of breakfast sausage here just in case.
You absolutely did. That could be a great one. Let's turn it over to Echo. Echo. What are you doing over here? How do you feel about, now, we have the heritage behind us here.
Yeah.
To use these corn tortillas properly.
La comida de mi gente.
Exactly. So what are you going to do with these?
I've got plenty of sausage left over. All the things that I wish I could have added a little bit earlier for some more flavor, I'm going to go ahead and put in there.
Nice.
And make some little tortillas.
Okay. So you're just going to make what, little tacos then?
Yeah.
Oh, that sounds really good. Are you going to do the thing that all abuelas do and cook it over the fire there and burn their fingers while they do it?
I've done that before and broken nails,
okay.
So I'm probably not going to do that. I'll just do it in the little saucepan.
All right, in the little saucepan is what she says there. Perfect.
I mean, these are beautiful. We don't
know. I don't know. My grandma's willing to do that. She's willing to burn her fingers for
well,
my...
Well, maybe when I'm an abuela, but right now, no.
We all get there eventually, Echo. We all get there eventually. What are you doing crushing those into there?
I'm just trying to kind of get some of that to soften up and release a little bit before I put it in.
Yeah.
So judges, I hope you like a little bit of spice.
I believe Dante said he likes spice. Bernice is nodding her head saying, yeah, she likes spice. We got another ingredient coming out here in just a moment here.
Bring it.
Chefs, is there anything in particular you could need before Amanda comes back out here? Let's see, what would you possibly need from your squad at this moment?
Oh, cheese would be great.
Cheese, that's a really...
Like any sort of cheese always goes well with Mexican
food.
Yeah,
absolutely, that sounds fantastic. And here comes Amanda with some ingredients here for you. Neither of those look like cheese, Amanda.
No, sorry. We're out for now. And you were gifted another heat source in case you were tired of the panini press. You
now
get a
smaller.
Mini George Foreman.
Oh, George Foreman.
And again, with the spices, you got cayenne pepper and you have chipotle peppers.
Oh, I got so many peppers. Thanks, guys.
Those look great.
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
You've got
all
a lot.
The spices.
Yeah, you know what I want to show you here. You've got the tortillas, but you've also got chili negro, and then you've also got some chipotle peppers, you've got cayenne,
peppers.
You've got sherry, you've got hot paprika. You've got a lot of spicy ingredients here. They could make something out of
it. They want me to eat it.
that's it
really
exactly.
Going for.
Oh boy. And then they've also got, is that what you're going to use the rest of your breakfast sausage for, maybe?
I think so. I think this is what's going to go best with the with the tortillas. And so we'll see.
It seems like Echo there, you almost seem to have known ahead of time what was going to come out there. You saved so much of your turkey.
My turkey?
Yeah. Isn't that, breakfast sausage, I'm an idiot.
Yes. Yeah, you are.
I'm just sitting there like, turkey.
The only reason I can do this is because the next round moved along faster than I could put that somewhere else.
Absolutely. I mean, it looks great, it looks absolutely delicious, nice and browned now and everything.
You
can make a little bit of some turkey tacos and whatnot there. We've got another vote coming out here with a ingredient for the purple squad here. So purple squad, get ready, you're gonna have a force ingredient just a moment. Oh, you need a... just put the blue plate underneath there, just for now. We'll get you a paper plate there, a little grease trap, so that you can have that in just a second. Scores are going to be coming through any moment here. They're currently voting on the forced ingredients, though.
Okay.
And here comes Amanda, Amanders, with the forced ingredient here, and two regular ingredients for you, Echo.
Okay. All right, Green Squad. You were gifted tamari and mushrooms. Very kind.
Yay!
And
I'm so in love with Green Squad.
We have this delicious forced ingredient for the Purple Squad. M&M's!
Are they at least the peanut M&M's? No.
Nope.
They're not even the good kind.
Good job, Green Squad.
Wowee. So Green Squad, I'm showing... I thought the ingredient person was supposed to be impartial. Let me go ahead and walk over to the judges here real quick. We'll come back to you, chefs, in just a moment here, see what you're doing. Judges, I'm on my way over here to talk to you. Oh, are you still judging? No, you're not.
No, we're eating.
Oh,
we're
okay, you're eating.
Okay.
So let's start with Bernice. I started with you last time, Bernice. What did you think about the two dishes that you had here? Just a quick rundown.
I'm pretty happy with the taste with both. It's pretty close call, but I think for complaint, the fluffiest dish is more presentable.
Ooh,
I think that's for me, that wins the tip over on his side. Yeah.
Awesome. And Dante, how are you feeling?
Damn, I kind of disagreed.
Really?
I thought the contrast of those beautiful peppers with the oil and the glaze looked better. For me,
got the indigestion going.
That breakfast sausage is talking back. For me, those Bernice, I didn't taste her tiger sauce.
You didn't? Oh wow! You didn't. Neither
didn't
of you tasted the tiger
cherries.
Sauce.
Ooh. So that could have been an easy drizzle.
Yeah.
It's a breakfast sausage. You're supposed to get your sweet and savory.
Sure.
I was really looking
not
for just a little.
Not enough of it.
There
I
wasn't
the sweetness,
any.
Though.
You did taste
it. I did.
It.
Yeah, because for sweetness, you don't want to overpower. You don't want to give too much. So you know.
It was the main ingredient.
Is it main?
It was the main. It was a forced ingredient.
Well. Yeah.
It was a forced ingredient. So let's see what the judge, or let's see what the judges said here. We'll get those scores up in just a moment, and then we'll turn our attention back to the chefs here in a minute as well. So for those final scores. Jesus, from over there. Purple squad for this dish came up 44 to 41 green squad. So good job, purple squad there, making up some ground overall. Let's see here, it came down to, actually it was pretty even, the 2-point penalty from Dante, which I'm assuming was for not tasting the featured ingredient.
It was supposed to be a featured ingredient.
Or a forced ingredient. So it was just the 2 points there. Otherwise, it would have been much closer. Well, great job, Purple Squad. It's very close now. It is 80 to 81, I believe. But I'm going to head back over there. Thank you so much, judges.
No problem.
And so voting is going again right now. Welcome back, everybody. I'm back over on the chef's side. Ooh, Echo. So we've missed some stuff here. What's going on in there? That is some mushrooms being cooked into that. That is some peppers being cooked into that. You've got the chilies being cooked into that. It's amazing.
You know, throwing some extra textures and flavors in there since I got it. Thank you, Green Squad. And I got a little bit of stuff that I'm trying to get all in the different dishes here.
Yeah.
I'm waiting for those judging categories.
Yeah, absolutely. Those will come a little bit later here. I'm going to turn it over to InstaFluff. InstaFluff, how's it going here?
You. Yeah, may I actually use this now? Because it's really loud.
Yeah, go for it. No, you could have used that anytime. Go for it. Great work. Jesus. That is so loud.
All right.
Wow.
There we go.
What is your plan with that? That is a forced ingredient that he's got here. What are you doing?
I wanted to blend the M&Ms to be kind of like add the sweetness a little bit as a powder on top of the tortilla sausages.
Oh, wow.
And
okay.
So I figured it'd be more kind of like sugar.
Yeah.
Almost like a sweet breakfast.
So you're trying to really powder it so that it can just be a brushing, a little dusting on top of that.
Exactly.
That's awesome. We did hear from those judges. They wanted more of the force. Do you think doing anything more with it would be a negative thing?
I'm not sure how they would turn out, but we'll see.
Well, let's see here.
Try it.
And then Echo currently flipping tortillas in the back there. She is going real quick here. Both of you seem to be well along the way. We've got a force ingredient on its way out here in just a second here for you with only 11 minutes and 30 seconds left on the clock here to go, Echo.
Okay.
Looks like you're up by 1 point, though, so far.
Okay.
So you're doing all right here, even though you're getting those force ingredients a little bit late in the rounds. And here comes Trolley Amanda with all of the ingredients here. Amanda.
Doot, doot.
She's not
beep,
doing
beep.
Beep, beep.
Okay.
Purple Squad was granted vodka. You can drink this or put it in your food. I'm not judging.
I don't think he's cooking with that.
Did you bring the shot glass?
Who needs one? We have cream cheese for you. And Echo, I know how much you love coffee. So you're being forced to put coffee creamer in your food. Peppermint mocha flavor.
Oh,
great
really?
Choice.
Oh, my.
Okay.
That's a real bad force ingredient. Judges, let's turn that over to the judges real quick and see how that's going to pan out for them. Dante, Bernice, we'll start with Dante this time. Dante, we got coffee creamer. This is peppermint mocha on Echo's side. And then on InstaFluff's side over there, they've got M&Ms. How are you feeling about those?
You know, the M&Ms actually were kind of cool.
Yeah.
I think he didn't use it properly. He got it too fine.
Okay.
You need your street taco. You use cabbage to get your crunch. So we can use, exactly.
That's interesting.
A little crinkle like a crackle if you wouldn't have went too fine.
You might be surprised, though. Let's see.
It didn't surprise me yet, I'll just say, you know. And then with Echo, you know, it almost could have been a dessert thing.
Yeah.
She could figure out how to maybe make crepes out of those tortillas and use the cream, and she's got that tiger sauce. We could get a crepe. I don't know.
Ooh, how are you feeling over there, Bernice, about those force ingredients? We got the peppermint mocha creamer, and we've got the M&Ms.
Yeah, I mean, the creamer could be good, but then, like, the peppermint mocha sounds so complicated.
Yeah.
Other than dessert, I don't even know what will taste good. The M&Ms, I think Fluff is very clever. Like, I actually can disagree with Dante. I feel like the way he did it could be could be, have potential to be very clever and great, but I don't know. It's too early to tell.
Yeah, absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, that it's too early to tell is what they've said. Dante gave you a little bit of advice there. Is that what you're going to go with?
Oh, my God, yes. Thank you.
Oh, and Amanda is back with a sabotage as well.
Oh, great.
Here we go, Green Squad. You got some time, along with all your other 5 million seasoning. Not actual time. That'd be nice, though. But you got this kind of time.
Thank you.
And some more hot sauce. This is XX extra hot sauce.
That's the porn kind.
Yeah, it's the inappropriate kind. Be careful with that. And then Green Squad voted that Raphael needs to read this children's book before he can continue anything.
Oh, man. All right. Well, hold on. Let's maybe pull that off there, because that seems to be burning pretty bad.
Uh-oh.
All right, so we just don't want it to smoke up in here.
Yep.
Go ahead and read that children's book while you're blowing away smoke there, Raphael.
Oh my goodness. All right, this book is called Mooba La 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 by Sandra Bunton. Bounton for Caitlin May. All right, Caitlin May out there. Here we go. It says,
it's a fluff. You have 8 minutes.
My cow says moo. A sheep says baa. Three singing pigs say la la la. No, you say, that isn't right. The pigs say oink all day and night. Rhinoceroses say snort and snarf. And the Liz dogs go ruff, ruff, ruff. Some other dogs go bow, wow, wow. I'm the captain of catastrophe. And the cats and the kittens say meow. Quack, says the duck. A horse says neigh. It's quiet now, what do you say? I don't know, what does the fox say though?
Perfect, pulling out a meme at the last second there. That was good. I don't want to throw this because this is Steve's daughter's book. So I'm just going to hang. You know what? It's mine now. All right, everybody. So we've got some sabotages also coming out for Green Squad here in just a moment there. Although I feel like you've been sabotaged quite a bit there, Echo. How are you feeling?
I am thrilled about more sabotages.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh, here she comes. What do you got for us, Amanda?
Well, we have salt for Purple Squad.
Oh, God.
Woo!
Regular salt.
There you go. And Green Squad has to have their heat minimized, which means turned off.
Ooh. So we'll swap any heat source with the mini maker.
Yeah.
So Raphael.
I'll get that.
Where are you at? What are you doing over there? Raphael.
Putting a bunch of cream cheese.
Do you want me to move some things over here so you can plate, so you can
possibly
do what you're doing on the front table? So Raphael, you need to pick which heat source you would like to replace of Echo's with the mini maker. Now, I don't know if there's a time limit on that guy or not.
Oh, can I replace the burner, one of the burners?
Okay.
Or front burner?
Front burner?
Yes.
Okay, burner with the mini maker.
It's fine.
Thank you, Amanda, who's running out here with it. Thank you very much. I appreciate that. There you are, Echo. Right. So your front burner is now replaced with the mini maker.
It's all good.
It's all good. You look like you had finished with your tortillas there.
Basically.
Awesome. So she is already ahead of that sabotage as well. I'm going to clear off some spots here for you, Raphael. That way you can, you don't really have a lot. You've got like a mess that looks like a diaper here sitting on your sitting on your table.
That's basically what it is.
It's basically a diaper.
Yes.
All right, perfect.
Food diaper.
A bunch of paper towels just all in a mess here. Now, I want to ask you real quick, what happened here to this panini press, or to the George Foreman and your pork shoulder?
Yeah.
You cooked that pretty quick.
I was trying to cook it beforehand so that, because I knew it was gonna cook a little bit slower.
Yeah.
But I think it cooked a lot faster than I expected.
Cooked pretty quick there. Amanda, what do you got for us?
So, Echo.
Yes.
Your squad re-gifted you the pink Himalayan salt.
They re-gifted.
That's fantastic. You
that's
know,
really
it's
nice
what you do at Christmas.
Yeah.
Take the gifts you got, you know, and you might not necessarily need anymore, and you just
give it right back.
Thanks, everybody.
Yeah. And your guys' scoring category for this round, one of them is going to be texture.
Texture.
Great
texture.
So, see, all that's
over.
Perfect. That's a normal scoring category. I saw Dante over there go, like, yeah, this is a normal scoring category, finally. Something that I can actually judge on. So, texture for both of you there.
Okay.
Oh, and we also want to thank Bonsai Baby for apparently rated us there.
Yay! So,
yay, Bonsai!
Oop, and sorry you cut out there, production. I could not hear you. Oh, wow. Welcome, everybody. Welcome from Bonsai Baby's stream. We appreciate you being here. If you like what you're seeing, please do join a squad. You can join the Green Squad or the Purple Squad, whatever you like here. And let's see what we got going on here now. Now, remember everybody, you can join a squad to choose to vote on whatever you want to see happen on the screen. You can pick ingredients for each one of these chefs to use. You can pick scoring categories that the dishes will be judged on. That's actually what Purple Squad is voting on right now. You could be voting on sabotages to sabotage each one of these chefs into doing something funky. That way it ruins their dish as well. So this is all viewer controlled. It's all whatever you want to have happen here. Whatever you want to have happen to these chefs, you get to decide here. So join a squad. Click that little button in the middle of your screen that actually says, click here to join a squad, play for free. Now let's see what's going on here. Echo,
yes.
Why do you have Pepto-Bismol on your table here? What happens?
You know, when you're eating a wide variety of food, it's really good to just be prepared for the indigestion.
Yeah, no, absolutely. I have constant heartburn. I'm a sufferer of that. I could absolutely use that.
Perfect.
A little bit of Pepto. Look at that.
I'm ready for you.
Okay, could I ask what that is? Well, what did you make that out of?
Well, this is my forced ingredient with the tiger's blood.
Okay.
So you wanted more tiger's blood, you got it.
I did not.
Yeah. You're getting more tiger's blood. Amanda, what do you got for us here?
Purple Squad, you got some eggs. Ooh. Really excited about that.
Eggs, yes.
And this scoring category, I have no idea what it means, but I like it. And it's winter.
Winter?
Look, this winter. Is so holiday-like. Ooh,
yeah, peppermint. Just saying, judges.
Ooh,
winter,
all right.
Peppermint.
A little smoky in here. Judges.
Sorry about that.
Judges, how do you feel about those scoring categories? We got texture and we got winter. Let's start with Dante this time. Dante, how you feeling about those?
Still mad he ground up those damn M&Ms. He'd have got his texture, you know what I mean?
I don't know. They could be, they're
I'm wow, judging that's good. I'm judging him. I'm being a dad.
I get it, I get it. And then how are you feeling about that?
The texture? Yeah. I think
both, maybe.
I am a texture person, so yeah. I'm excited to judge on the texture. And winter, I think it's pretty, I mean, to me, it's self-explanatory.
Yeah.
Like, I want comfort, warm, some flavor. Yeah, so that's what I'm looking for.
Absolutely. Now, chefs, we do want to remind you here, in just a second, you only have 2 minutes to go here, both of you. You guys got a boat plate. He's so zen half the time. I just turned to him and he's just slow, like 2 minutes left on the clock. He's just shoving a little piece of food in his mouth there. So you've only got 2 minutes. What is it that you've made here for the judges? Get a little overhead shot of this guy here. What do you got there?
A snowflake breakfast sausage quesadilla.
Okay, gotcha. Have you actually cooked the tortillas?
No, I didn't.
Okay, well then, so you're serving them cold tortillas, but it's got some cooked meat in it.
They're actually not cold.
Okay.
They're actually just room temperature.
Have you finished all three of your plates?
I have.
You have?
Just
wow. We got to clear up some space here for you, man.
Yeah, I've been trying to taste test it to make sure that they taste them.
Uh-huh. And what is your analysis of that?
Well, I put some cayenne pepper a little bit onto the breakfast sausage along with the M&Ms, ground up M&Ms.
Uh-huh.
And I love that it counterbalances between the sweet and spicy.
Awesome. And then we've got 2 minutes or 1 minute left on the clock. What do you got for us, Amanda?
We've got a banana. Thanks. All right. Also, we have fresh mint. So now you have some double mint going on.
Ooh.
If you wanted that. And I think a third saucepan.
Wow.
Great.
A lot of saucepans.
So, yes. Now I have a fancy hat.
Perfect. All right. Perfect. Echo, you've got 30 seconds left. What are you doing here? How close are you to being finished with these tortillas?
Super close. I've just got to get my little dessert tortillas very last.
This smells really good. I gotta say, judges, this smells delicious right now.
Is she gonna plate it all?
Is she gonna plate it all? With 20 seconds left, chefs, you've only got, well, Instafluffs over here is already done, so I'm turning over to Echo, who's almost finished. Where's your pink sauce on these?
In my little
You've
dessert,
got
guys.
10 seconds left here, Echo. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and plate down, everybody. I don't know what to say there. Hands off, everybody. Go and deliver them to your judges, your chefs.
Uh-oh.
All right. Oh, boy.
There we go. I will go first. These are some wintry snowflake breakfast sausage. It's got a little bit of kick.
Okay, thank
sweet
you.
Sweet and spicy. And so, hope you guys enjoy.
So we have your street tacos with a nice little kick to it. Mm-hmm. And if you're feeling generous, you could share the dessert with Dante.
Okay.
We've got a little bit of a cherry, mint, mocha, crepe kind of thing going on there.
Okay.
Thanks.
Cool. Thank you. I know you don't want me to share.
And
I will.
Welcome back.
Hello.
Oh. Welcome back over to here, judges, chefs, I'm sorry. And Amanda, what's our featured ingredient?
Here we have hot dogs for you guys, or as I like to call them, browned bologna sticks. Because I don't know what they're made of, and I don't know what bologna is made
of.
Perfect. But you have hot dogs.
Animal buttholes.
Oh.
Delicious.
Yes.
All right, so we've got the voting already started in the next round there. We've got 20 minutes on the clock here for you chefs. Go ahead and start cooking those hot dogs up. Already taking the pizza crust out. What are you going to do with the pizza crust in the...
Oh, I was going to make a hot dog out of it because I got mayo. I got spices. I got honey.
You're going to make hot dogs out of that pizza crust?
Yeah.
That Mamma Mia pizza... Oh, of wait, course. What is that?
Mamma Mary's.
I'm sorry.
Mamma Mia.
Sorry, I'm over here breaking out into ABBA songs.
Says creep bacon and enjoy.
No, it looks good. Go for it. You do your thing. That is an awesome plan there. Echo, let's turn it over to you real quick. Look. Now, you've got some goop on that. You got some
just
pink tortilla
schmuck.
Goo on that. Now, you might have to make a strong comeback here as your fourth ingredient from the last round only made it on one of the two plates there.
But they're going to share.
They're going to share.
It's okay.
All right. Let's see what happens there. Let's see what they do for you. Now, what are you going to do with these with these hot dogs here?
I'm just going to make little hot dog men.
Are you going to make squid?
No, just little hot dog men.
Hot dog men.
I can make a squid for you.
Are you preemptively trying to guess what the voting round is going to be?
I don't know what I'm doing with these hot dogs, so I'm going to make little hot dog men.
That sounds like a good plan to me. I like the idea that hot dogs can be turned into little men, little meat men. Well, if that's the best you could do right now, that's the best you could do. We've only got about 10 seconds before another vote's going to come through here.
Perfect.
So Purple Squad, you're going to be getting your first thing. What could you be using right now, Raphael? Anything in particular?
Hot dog buns would be great because these don't smell like hot dog buns.
What? Hold on. Yeah, it smells like hot dog buns. You're right. That smells like a hot dog bun. So Purple Squad's vote's coming through here. So you'd use that. What do you need? Ketchup, mustard?
Ketchup would be great. Or mustard.
Oh, shoot, the book I stole.
Or the book. I could use the book.
No, you can't use the book. Still hiding that one. Here comes Amanda with... mustard and ketchup. Just what you wanted.
I know you said you wanted ketchup. So Purple Squad gave you refried beans. And angel hair pasta.
Oh, thank you.
And along with the left back burner.
Ooh, the back burner this time.
The back burner.
Also.
I use the back burner so much.
Unlimited water.
That's always going to be a thing, unlimited water there. Now.
All right.
Raphael, you've got so many things on here. Why is Echo's so much easier to look at than your station at the moment? What has happened? A food diaper. All right, you made the food diaper. Now, here's the thing. Do you think those refried beans actually could be used with those, with the hot dogs? Yeah. I don't think that's a bad idea.
Yeah, it actually sounds really great because I make like chili dogs almost.
Yes, see, look at that. Yeah. Now you're thinking. You got the hot paprika.
Yep.
You got things like the chilies. You've got the chipotle peppers. You can mix all that stuff up together with that to make a really good little chili almost.
Ooh, I think I might actually do that.
Yeah, there we go.
Got Tabasco sauce.
I'm full of good ideas. Now, what do we got over here, Echo? We're waiting for your first vote to come through. You still got little hot dog men. Now you're actually cooking them.
Little hot dog men, and I'm going to just see what goes from there.
I want to bring attention to the fact that your hot dog men went back together? Like, they've just sort of got, how do they cook so that they stay as hot dog men? They've just sort of...
They cook, they'll split.
They'll split, okay.
Yeah.
So, have you made, a bento before and done little hot dog squids?
Yeah.
I was gonna say, you should do hot dog squids. Those are the best. Ooh, pardon me, everybody. Got the indigestion as well. You should have saved some of that Pepto-Bismol for me.
Oh, yeah, I dumped it. Sorry.
Okay, gotcha. You dumped it. Well, here comes your first ingredient as well. And in addition to that, we've got a forced ingredient on the way for the Purple Squad. Good job, Green Squad, for voting for that. Purple Squad, right now on your screen, what you should be seeing is some ingredients for you to vote on and a forced ingredient to force on the Green Squad here. Now, Amanda's coming back out here with the forced ingredient.
Right now we got pizza sauce for the Green Squad.
This is forced?
No.
Okay.
Not for you. You can use that if you want to. Thank you. And you got a steamer.
Oh, great.
Yeah, you use that with that cauliflower.
And then forced on Purple Squad, you have Spam.
Yes, yeah, Spam.
Not the reaction I expected.
Ponyo loves Spam.
And who did we hear there from production there who's gifted another sub there? Pokemon
Hero? Pokemon Hero.
Oh, He's great. Raphael, you CL'd Pokemon over here. Yes, Pokemon is great. Thank you so much for gifting that sub. We do really appreciate that. It does help keep the channel going, and we hope to see you folks in the future there. So let's go ahead and walk over to our judges here, who are continuing to eat the food, it looks like. I'm going to walk over here and see what they thought about that last dish. All right. Now, judges, how's it going? How are you doing today?
Hi.
What is that?
There's a little heat.
Is there a little heat?
She didn't judge those peppers too well.
Uh-oh.
I mean, I don't mind it, but I'm pretty sure the average person wouldn't have ate as much as we did of those. They were definitely a wintry.
Okay, gotcha.
Nose clear, if you know what I mean.
All right, gotcha. That's the Arbol chilies?
Yeah.
Okay, ooh, gotcha. I figured that was pretty warm. Ooh. Yeah, I put quite a lot in there.
I ate them all, but yeah, it was a little warm.
Okay, quick rundown of the two dishes.
Night and day, one was good, one was bad.
Okay.
But one didn't get served to me properly.
So wow.
For me, they were about the same.
All right, and how did you feel about them, Bernice?
What did I sign on the waiver to be on this show? I mean, I spit it out with this guy.
Wow.
Yeah, the snowflake, and it's cold, and I think the texture is kind of gross, and it just like, I don't know what that white thing is, but it's like a little gross to me.
What was the...
So that's Raph's dish, and then so now on Echo's dish, actually I think it tastes good, but I think it's a little bit too spicy, but the flavor is generally good, but the dessert is a little sad.
Like, okay,
I don't know how to describe it, but the the medicine?
Yeah,
that's probably the best way to describe it.
Okay, like Pepto-Bismol. All right, so that was a good descriptor of that. Let's go ahead and see what the judges rated and what the final scores were for this round here. We'll find out there in just a moment, and then we'll turn our attention back over to our chefs to see what they're doing. Oh, wow. This was a low scoring category. Purple squad 17 and green squad 22.
Woo!
So green squad still is up there. Wow. With a minus 10 penalty from Dante, green squad, and a minus 4 purple penalty to the green squad, still coming out on top there. Oof. Oh boy. That is good stuff.
So there's rules on here for missing.
There are. You can do what you
that
want.
That was late dish completion too, by her having to spread it. I mean,
yeah. No,
I
we got it.
I got to throw a dog a bone over there. I mean, she's picking on invalid anyways. You know, make it even.
All right. So let's go ahead and turn our attention back over to the chefs there. Thank you, judges. Come back to you soon.
Thank you.
All right. So we've got the votes going on there for another forced ingredient here. We should see that in just a second for you, Echo. You should be getting some a forced one in a second here.
I'm so excited.
Know what you can put on those. Oops.
I'm not sure how this is gonna work.
Wow, we've got 5 more subs from gift subs from Pokemon Hero. Thank you so much, Pokemon Hero.
Thank you.
And then let me say Amanda, or let me go with Amanda here, and we'll find out the next gifted sub there.
All right, Purple Squad, you gave Raphael soy sauce.
Uh-oh.
And another spicy thing, spicy ketchup.
Oh, this is great. Thank you so much, guys.
And Green Squad.
Yes,
Your forced ingredient is going to be shredded coconut.
Great, whatever, I'll make it work. Great, we can do this,
shredded
great.
Shredded coconut. In production, can I get the second person who, Neozylium? Wow, Neozylium, thank you so much for subbing to us again. Thank you, Pokemon Hero, as well. We very much appreciate it. Y'all have been very kind to us today. We very much enjoy having you all here. We hope to see you returning back to the stream. Thank you so much for gifting those subs and subbing to the channel. So you've got a forced ingredient there. What was your forced ingredient? I was focusing on our subs there. Was it the shredded coconut?
Yes, I'm gonna toast the coconut.
Ooh, all right. You're toasting the coconut. Now, does that go with hot dogs?
We'll find out.
And we'll find out whether or not hot dogs goes with coconut. I'm looking over to Dante, seeing if he's shaking his head or going like yes or no. He's a very opinionated chef.
I've noticed.
You just eat a banana for your heart health?
Uh-huh.
Potassium is good for it.
Yeah, so lower I don't get any cramps.
Oh, got it. Good to know. And we've got a sabotage that's going to be coming out here in just a second. Raphael, you're toasting the pizza crust, or trying to anyway.
I'm trying to.
You're trying to. That's
we'll
a little
see.
Small there.
Yeah.
You've only got about 10 minutes,
small.
31 seconds
we'll
left
see.
On the clock.
I just need it to be a little bit warm. So
just a little bit warm is what you need.
Cracking up.
even though that round wasn't so good, right now you're only about 6 points behind. You can still come out and
win this.
We can
do this, purple team. We got this. We got this. I got the hot dogs cooking.
Yeah, look at that. On the panini press, Echo, or not Echo, I'm sorry, Amanda is out here.
Wow. Same person. That again?
Pretty much same person. Trolley Amanda.
I'll take it.
There
okay.
we go.
Green Squad was gifted peanut butter.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay. And blueberries.
Blueberries?
Yep. Blueberries.
And Purple Squad, you have to complete this puzzle that's on the floor.
Oh, no.
All right. So go ahead and complete that puzzle over there, Raphael. It's been pretty much completed for you. Go ahead and go there, my friend. You've got 9 minutes and 35 seconds left to complete that. I'm hoping that they've got a good shot of you completing that. So it's been partially completed, so he'll only have to complete, I think, 35 pieces total, which isn't too bad. Oh, wow. He's speeding along getting this princess puzzle going. This is a lot faster than Kells had done it last time. We had another person in the studio trying to do this. It didn't go so well last time. Oh,
still not.
Hey, Raphael, you also might want to just... Oops, the book I stole fell out.
Oh.
You might want to...
Those might be easy.
There you go. We're just going to put
the book there. I'm an expert at these.
Yeah, there we go. Now he's going. So you've... oh my God. Hold on a second. Well, I wanted to talk about what was going on with that puzzle. This smells really good over here. That toasted coconut, like, is actually being super aromatic and smells really good.
Yeah.
Like, that's surprisingly good. Are you worried about those burning, however?
Well, that's why I'm turning the heat off.
Okay, gotcha. No, I figured. I saw a couple of them getting a little toasty, so I figured you'd turn them down a little bit, but it smells amazing.
Yeah.
I don't know how it's going to go with a hot dog, but...
Very carefully.
Very carefully is what she says. Perfect. I'm glad that's happening. We got Amanda coming back out here with some more sabotages and ingredients. What do you got for us, Amanda?
Purple Squad gets couscous and a red onion.
Ooh.
So many things.
There's a lot of things on this table. Wow, you can't see anything on there.
And the sabotage is gonna be Alanis, which I believe is putting your hand on the faucet.
Yep, so Echo, go ahead and put your hand on that faucet for the next 5 minutes. There we go, and you realize that it pulls out, so go for it.
Oh, God.
These might as well be 2 5-minute sabotages as Raphael is still, let's get a shot of that as he's still going there. He's almost done with it. I mean, he's getting pretty quick at it. There's a corner piece. He's found that. Good job, man. I couldn't have done that quick.
My five-year-old might have, though.
Your five-year-old could have done it that quick, huh? Gotcha. All right. Now, we've got two sabotages going on. Judges, how are you feeling about those? It looks like Raphael got the short end of the stick here on this one. Like, he's spending a lot of his time fixing up this puzzle.
It's taken him longer than it should have. That's definitely for sure.
And
there we go.
He's done. Good job.
Oh, yeah.
Nice.
Good job. I'm going to move this out of the way so we can see the completed puzzle.
We're still trying to remember what the key ingredient is for InstaFluff.
Ooh, the forced ingredient?
Yeah.
Oh, I'm sorry. So forced ingredient for InstaFluff. InstaFluff, what was your forced ingredient?
I had a forced ingredient. I think it was a spam.
Oh, it was the spam is what he's got over there.
Oh, golly.
Yeah. He's got the spam and then Echo's forced ingredient over there. Echo, have you gotten yours already?
The coconut?
Oh, you got the coconut. Mm. All right.
Mm-hmm.
It's because they've done, I couldn't remember because they've done such a good job of just like, this is an ingredient I have to deal with now. So once they have that sort of attitude.
Excuse me?
InstaFluff, also remember to wash your hand after you've been touching the child's puzzles.
Yep.
Yes, please.
And we got Amanda back over here. Amanda, what have you got for us?
That puzzle looks great. I'm so proud of you.
Oh, thank you. I don't even know what the scene is, but it seems good.
It's a castle.
It's a castle.
With a unicorn.
Oh, there's a unicorn.
I think I saw a unicorn. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
All right, Amanda, what do we got?
All right, we got a medium bowl for the Green Squad.
Fantastic.
Along with, I don't know how you're going to use it, but the microwave.
Okay. I do have a glass I can use.
And then the scoring category is hybrid.
Like the car.
Yeah.
Hybrid.
Yeah.
Judges, hybrid. Chefs, hybrid is the first one there.
Great.
Enjoy. I hope that's satisfactory for you. Ooh, now InstaFluff. What these tortillas or these hot dog buns are not curving at all. They're toasting up and staying flat. You might have to make a pizza.
Yep.
I mean, you got the spicy ketchup there.
Yeah,
you got the hot dogs.
Go with it.
You're gonna have to, it seems like at this point. I mean, you've only got about 5 minutes left on the clock. 5 minutes, 30 seconds. Looks like he's gonna be toasting that up. Echo, you've got all your veggies sitting inside of that curry.
I do.
What are you doing? Are you just soaking up all the curry in there and that's it?
I'm making a thing.
Making a thing.
I'm
right,
not giving any clues.
I was trying to get more out of you. That way I could talk to.
I know.
Have more
to
talk about.
But what happens is if I'm like, oh, I'm going to make this thing, then everybody is going to be like, oh, what can I do to fuck that up?
Yeah.
And I'm not doing that.
No, that's your squad. That's your squad that'd be voting for you for good things.
Sure. But also there's people voting on sabotages.
It's true, and you're about to get your you already did your sabotage.
Yeah.
You already got it.
I know, but not on the last dish.
That's fine.
And I have a strategy.
We got another scoring category getting ready to come out here.
Okay.
I'm pretty excited about this because we've got hybrid as one of the scoring categories. That's worth 10 of the 30 points. And here comes Amanda with our second scoring category. What do you got for us, Amanda?
So, two rounds later, you have your cheddar cheese.
Oh, I can actually make pizza now that we have 4 minutes left.
And your second scoring category, along with hybrid, is gonna be balanced meal.
Balanced meal.
I think they kind of go together.
Mm-hmm. With Spam and hot dogs.
All right, so judges, Dante and Bernice. Dante, I started with you. Bernice, let's start with you this time. Mm-hmm. That's hybrid and I already
balanced
forgot the scoring category.
The
meal. Yeah. And balanced meal. My memory's gone, I'm sorry. Balanced meal. The thing was, is hybrid threw me off. It's like, what the fuck am I gonna do with balanced meal on hybrid?
I came up with my own interpretation. So hybrid, I'm gonna interpret almost like a fusion, right? So, you know, some of the ingredients with different cuisine could combine together, and I would just define it as a fusion. I think span with anything else is probably a good, like already. And coconut, that's, you can add fusion. Balance the meal, I just like, don't fuck up.
Shit got real. Shit just got real over here. All right.
Dante, how you feeling?
I'm scared.
Yeah? What about the scoring categories? Hybrid?
I don't even know. I'm thinking like, you gotta do something two ways or have two sides to your dish. Maybe a surf and turf idea, maybe two flavors, just some yin and yang somehow.
How about balanced meal?
I need two things this time.
Okay.
I can't just get, you know, just your meatball or just, you gotta put in some effort this round. You've had a couple other rounds to do some other things and have the ingredients working, so.
All right, well thank you both to our judges here. We'll come back to you real quick here in just a couple minutes, deliver those dishes to you. Amanda's all the way, is coming back onto the screen here. Some more ingredients. Echo, you're done with your sabotage. What do you got for us, Amanda?
You are given capers and sriracha.
Oh, thank you.
You can finally compete with the spice over here.
Woo-hoo.
Yeah, really. Well, I mean, you got all these spices, but nothing that would be considered actually spicy.
Right.
Or hot spicy. And you didn't really get a whole lot of Raphael over here. You didn't get a whole lot of regular spices, but a lot of things that were
very spicy.
Very spicy. You totally got complete opposites on this, but that's not terribly bad. What have you done with your sort of refried beans here?
I am making a Mexican pizza with the refried beans for the veggies.
Okay.
And we got some protein and we got some flour and everything. So I think it's very balanced over here.
Yeah, are you gonna spread the beans out or are you just gonna leave them like plopped on there?
That's exactly what I'm gonna do. And then I'm gonna put the little pieces of the sausage on top as toppings.
Okay.
And then top it up with some of the more sauces, the spicy ketchup, I think sounds really great.
What about the Spam?
The Spam also will go in there.
This is a meat lover's pizza here.
Yes. It's a meat and veggie bean lover's pizza.
Ooh, green team, apparently, you have the front right burner.
Yes.
I believe that was taken away at one point. Oh, you just got it back from production in my ear saying they voted on it to give you it back.
Oh.
Yeah, because you had the griddle, remember?
Yes.
I don't know if you've been using it this entire time or not, but it doesn't matter because you got away with it.
Yes.
That's a... Dante giving out a loud yes over there for that. So it doesn't matter. So we've only got about chefs. I want to inform you we've got about 1 minute left before you have to get this served over to them. I'm curious about what's happening over here on Echoes. It's very pretty looking. You've got hot dog men over there. I don't know if either judges were looking forward to eating hot dogs today. Well, that's what you're getting.
But they're cute.
They are cute. I like this. You got one hot dog guy left to go there. We got 30 seconds left on the clock
Wait,
as well.
I gotta do. Oh.
Just wanted to remind you there of that one.
I lost my man.
Ooh, Instafluff. Instafluff, what are you doing over here? You've got your hot dog pepperoni. Okay, and he just shoved one in his mouth. I was waiting to see you just place them all, and you ended up taking a little bite of it.
Yep.
We've got about 10 seconds. Nine, eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. And zero, hands off, chefs, and go ahead and take your stuff over to the judges there. Dante is already shaking his head. Go ahead and bring your stuff over there, Raphael.
Hi.
I'm not sure that looks like a man. I'm not gonna tell you what it looks like, okay?
You know what? All right, so we've got your hot dog with a little bit of spice. And a hybrid dessert taco. You've got fresh fruit, mint, some toasted coconut, and a little bit of peanut butter to kind of bind it all together. Enjoy.
Yay. You've already contained myself.
We've got a gourmet Mexican pizza with
gourmet. Okay.
It's a what would you call it? A fusion pizza. It's almost like Hawaiian Mexican with some refried beans and some spam on top and some spicy ketchup.
Got it.
Okay.
I feel like I'm back in jail.
I can't say bon appetit. I know the petit is not there.
All right.
I got out of jail a couple weeks ago, and this is what it looks like when you're in there. Don't go. Don't go. I'm telling you, this is like commissary food. You know, this is what they call the hookup. I'm sorry.
All right, everybody. Here, you get the beanies and weenies.
Exactly. This is a man. Never mind. Sorry.
So let's go ahead and turn it back over to here. Chefs, you are good to go. We got 20 minutes. Whoop. Just heard a loud production in my ear. I couldn't hear that production. If you want to say that one more time. Okay, they said forget it. So we've got the pork shoulder as that last ingredient. We got 20 minutes on the clock there. If you chefs want to go ahead and go. Now yours is already going. Is the thing. You've been going this entire time. Where's your pork shoulder?
Cooking.
Perfect, Echo. That's great TV. We've got it. So no, that's the thing, is Echo, you very early melted your curry cubes into that.
Mm-hmm.
And your pork is actually resting and has been cooking in that.
Yes.
This entire time.
Yes.
That's
just
awesome.
Because Green Squad loves me. Thank you.
And I've got the hiccups right now, so I'm trying not to speak. And Raphael, now here's the thing. You've got your pork shoulder already going. Have you seasoned that guy at all?
I did. I actually had it simmering in the sauce and everything earlier with the sherry over here.
Simmering?
Well, not simmering, but it was just like.
Do you know what simmering
not
is?
Not simmering.
I was going to say, that's been on a grill
I'm
this entire
spam
time.
Right now.
No, that's fine.
I got a whiff
good?
Of this vodka. Oh, yeah.
Oh, you got good. A whiff of the vodka.
Yeah.
Are you not a drinker yourself?
Not very often. I like red wine, like Spanish red wines.
Yeah, no. Spanish red wines. A man of class,
so
he is. So, all right, what have you been doing to this? Are you going to leave that on there for very long? You've got it on a very high heat. My worry is that the time is going to run out very fast. Or, I mean, the time is going to take quite a while, and what's going to happen is that's going to cook very fast, is what I meant to say.
Oh, yeah. Well, I lowered it now just a little bit, but it wasn't on max yet.
Yeah.
So I would like to at least have it cooked.
Yeah.
No one wants uncooked or rare pork.
Would you mind popping it open just for a second, just so we could see that and see how it's going? Looks like it's cooking real quick. That center's going to need to be cooked. We have the thermometer here, so we can actually check exactly how hot your pork is.
Oh,
both
great.
Of y'all.
Let's do it.
Oh, you want to do that right now?
Let's do it.
All right, go for it, Raphael.
All right,
you got
see.
It. And what's it coming out to right now?
112.4.
All right, needs to be a lot hotter than that to be able to be edible, Raphael.
There we go. Got this.
But you've got 17 minutes left. 17 minutes. No, I wouldn't. Okay, you know what? Do your thing. All right, so Echo, let's see what we got going on back here. Putting some sriracha into that curry.
Little kick, just
are
a
you,
bit.
Are you confident that your pork is going to come out cooked all the way? Because what I just saw Raphael do was turn his grill up to max when he realized his pork wasn't at the correct temperature. Now, the thing was is they've got 17 minutes and 25 seconds left.
Mm-hmm.
I think it could get to the correct temperature in that amount of time.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Plus, I cut mine into smaller pieces.
So yours is going to be cooked through pretty easily. Amanda, Oh. Welcome back.
Thank you, Ted. Purple Squad, to go along with your pork, we have sugar, pepper, and then a slotted spatula in case you needed it.
Oh, goodness, thank you. It's actually exactly what I needed.
All right.
Thank you so much.
Was it really what you needed?
I did. I was trying to find a spoon because I couldn't scrape the beans off because I ended up not using those beans. But I could have used this like 5 seconds
Perfect.
Earlier.
That's what you're going to use it for. Gotcha. We were just curious what you were going to... You sounded so excited about getting that slotted spatula.
It'd be really nice because this I can use to actually cook the eggs. I want to cook the eggs with the pork.
Wow, that sounds like a great idea. Maybe cut that pork up pretty small there and... I
think it's...
That could come out pretty good. Now, you've got 2 eggs total. Is that going to be enough for you there?
I think so.
Maybe a small portion?
Yep. Yeah, just very small portions.
Echo, we've got your vote coming out here in 10 seconds. I saw you just took that sesame oil to do something with it. What were you doing? Or rather, I could smell it.
There you go.
I have some little cauliflower that's been just kind of roasting over here.
Yeah, all right. Dante looks excited. Judge Dante looks real excited about that. I don't know if he actually is or not. I can't tell.
I am.
He is. A little bit of the sesame oil on that. Does sesame oil, does that go good on cauliflower? I've never had that.
Cauliflower just takes on the flavor of whatever you put on it. And I figure sesame oil has just enough of a little flavor to kind of give it a little something nice. Because I don't really have pepper.
Good. Yeah.
Like reasonable pepper. I'll just sprinkle a little bit of salt on that too when it's all done and call it a day.
Amanda, real quick, what do you got for us?
Green squad. We have green things for you.
Yay!
Green curry paste for you. plus the oven.
Okay.
Plus Purple Squad has to use these wasabi peas.
Ooh, wasabi peas. All right, thank you, Amanda. I'm gonna go ahead and walk over to our judges here and see what they thought of that last dish and get the scores for it. Judges, this is the fourth time I've seen you. We gotta stop meeting this way. How have you all been?
I'm not a judgy person. Yeah. I'm not always this much of an asshole.
No, that's
fine.
You're
making me out to look bad.
No, but you're literally here to be a judge. That's literally what you're here to do. All right, so let's go ahead and start with Bernice. Bernice, what did you feel about that last dish?
So first of all, in real life, I am a sweet person.
Yeah.
But what I'm about to say might not be that nice.
Uh-oh.
So, you know, the pizza?
Yeah.
I think it's a really great attempt, but I took a picture of it because I ate that thing is going on the internet because it's horrendous.
Going on the internet, okay, perfect. And the other dish?
The other dish, I think the hot dog, it's a hot dog on the side, but the sweet, the dessert thing, it's a little, surprisingly, it's actually good. Like, I like how it is, and I'm glad I get a little fruit. For the pizza, I think it's just like a whole bunch of things. Like the balanced meal, I think that's not a balanced meal for me.
Yeah.
I do think the try to hit the goal of like hybrid.
And Dante, quick rundown real quick.
I like Spam.
You look like you got whiskey.
I wish it was. It's kind of sometimes. But I like Spam, so for me the pizza really kind of hit its mark. It wasn't great. But with the idea of balanced meal and hybrid, because you're infusion pollen, I digged what he said. You know what I mean? He did do a little fusion. It was a balanced meal. You got your grain, you got your beans, you got your tomato, you got some meat. So, I mean, it was a balanced meal. I liked her presentation of the dessert thing.
Yeah.
It just wasn't formulated well. If it would have had more blackberries, less mint, more coconut, more peanut butter, it would have been perfect. There's a little bit too much mint.
Okay.
But she just made a plain hot dog, and that was your main ingredient.
Okay, so gotcha. Kind of...
It had eyes.
It had eyes, is what you're saying. So
That's the mom answer.
Let's get the scores here from the judges. Let's find out what they gave them. This is a very close round here. Oh my God, another close round. 36 for the Purple Squad and 35 for the Ninja Squad. So Purple Squad is making gains on you, Green Squad. You've only got a 5-point lead now instead of a 6-point lead. They could be coming back in this last round here. Mm-hmm. So thank you so much. There's no penalties this time, unfortunately, for both of them. I think the penalties are fun. I love seeing what y'all are knocking them down
for. We're facing the penalties. We're eating them.
No, gotcha. All right, so we're going to turn back over to the judges, or the chefs. Thank you so much, judges. Appreciate it. We'll see you in a little bit. All right, and we're gonna get the voting started again for this next forced ingredient here. You've got about 12 minutes, 20 seconds left here.
Yeah.
This is going good. What forced ingredient right now could really screw you over?
Nothing.
Because your squad is the, oh no, purple squad is voting on this. Nothing could be.
I'm on top of the world.
What are you gonna do if you get more tiger's blood?
Honestly, a little bit of sweet in a curry is not bad.
Okay, so whatever happens, you might be okay adding that in.
Yeah.
That's awesome. Are you certain that pork is gonna come out okay?
Yeah, like definitely cutting it into smaller pieces, I think helped. It's cooked through already, so now I just don't wanna like overdo it. But yeah, I'm just kind of waiting to see what kind of nonsense gets thrown my way.
Absolutely, and we just wanted to remind everybody, if you're watching for the first time, please do consider a follow or a subscription to us, as it does help out the channel quite a bit. If it is your first time just joining us here, there should be a little box on the front of the screen there that says join a squad, click to play for free, something along those lines there. Click that little box there. You will be able to join either the green squad or the purple squad, and you'll be able to vote on the ingredients, sabotages, the scoring categories. It's all about you controlling the action and deciding what happens here on screen. It's all about you telling these chefs what you want to see happen. So please do join a squad there if this is your first time there. Rafael, what do you got going on back there? You're grilling the pork that you had in the panini press.
Yep.
Into smaller pieces.
I did.
Yes.
So that they could cook faster.
Okay. Gotcha.
I realized I was running out of time.
I mean, you had 10 full minutes there. You might have been useful to save that, just so it didn't end up cold in the end there.
Oh, it'll be all right.
It'll be all right is what he's saying.
Yeah, I think so.
Sort of fumbling around with those pork pieces there, though, with that spatula.
Yeah. It would have been nice to get what are those called? The gripper things.
A tongs?
Yeah, that's it.
Gripper things. Everyone's favorite.
Gripper things are great.
What are those?
Like the castellettas? Gripper things.
Castanetas? All right, what do you got for us?
All right, Purple Squad gave you another heat source. You have a griddle, in case you need it.
Oh, goodness. Everything but the microwave.
You can grill your pork again.
No, Echo has the microwave.
Oh! Would you like a griddle?
Also, some fennel seeds. And I have the nonsense being thrown your way, which is marshmallows that you have to use.
Oh, no.
Wow.
All right, Echo.
Yeah, I will trade you the microwave for the griddle if you'd like.
Maybe for the vodka.
Oh, and the vodka? All right.
Wait, no.
What? Not. So wait, have you two just initiated is this going to happen, this trade between you two?
I hope so.
What are you trading for? Both of you.
He wants the microwave.
Instafluff, you want the microwave?
Do you like the vodka?
I would like the vodka.
And the griddle, maybe?
Look at this. What is happening?
Sure.
Thank you.
All right.
All right, well, there we go. That's it. Now you have the microwave. Okay.
And the
wait a minute.
She's drinking it.
Wait a minute. It's a flush. Now, please, don't tell me you're going to take the pork and put that in the microwave.
No. Okay. That's for the eggs.
You're fine.
This
what?
Great.
All right, well, he's going to microwave some eggs, everybody. The microwave man, the man of a million microwaves, is going to do that. Echo, what are you doing with the. Don't drink that vodka. You can if you want to. I'm not going to
stop you. The marshmallows have driven me to drink.
Okay, go for it. So there we go. Echo's taking the vodka. Now, what are you going to do with the marshmallows?
I am trying to figure that out.
All right. What happens? What if you melt those in a microwave?
I don't have the microwave, but I do have the front burner.
You do have both of the burners there.
I do.
Ooh, now that's something sweet. How does that curry taste? Could it use something sweet? You mentioned earlier you absolutely could.
Yeah, I'm thinking I'm gonna do some braining over here.
Yeah. Oh, and Amanda's back with nothing on the trolley. What do you got for us?
Wait for it. We have ground black pepper over from the Purple Squad. And the sabotage is gonna be saucy.
Saucy is the sabotage. Now, as I seem to remember, you can take any one of your sauces or liquids, one tablespoon of a liquid, any of them,
got it,
and put it into any one of his working dishes.
Okay.
Instafluff, did you have those tablespoon things? There we go.
I do.
Uh-oh. There we go. So one tablespoon of any of your liquids here. Oh, wow. Echo. She is taking the liquid from the capers. That is a deadly sabotage. What are you putting that into, Echo?
I will take a peek.
Wait. Wow. You still got those marshmallows. Maybe as eggs?
Huh. They're in the microwave.
They are.
I hurried.
I hurried.
That doesn't bother me.
Oh, no.
I have to give you the sabotage.
She wants to win so bad.
I'm gonna spill all of this.
That's assuming she could get it in there. She spilled half of it already.
Oh, goodness.
Oh, Echo.
I might be doing you a favor. You never know.
I don't think this is a favor in any way.
Boozy eggs.
I don't know what's happened. Boozy eggs, did you say? That was No, that was caper liquid. That's not
caper
vodka.
Liquid?
Yes.
Oh.
There was this.
Oh.
Here you go. You can smell.
Oh, actually, that smells pretty good.
No.
Is that why it's food?
It doesn't. I swear.
I gotta use these wasabi peas, though, right?
Yeah, you have to use those wasabi peas. Those are a forced ingredient. They are really good. Can I have one? Mm. Yeah, thank you. I am a big fan of. Right? Mm. Ooh, thank you. I'm a big fan. What do you got for us, Amanda?
All right, Purple Squad. They gave you a nice, huge yellow onion and some club crackers.
Crackers.
And the sabotage is deserted on the Green Squad.
Ooh, deserted. That means you don't get any more water for the rest of the game.
But I can still wash my hands, right?
You can still wash your hands. I'm overruling that. I don't know if that's what they intended. You can still wash your hands and your knife and stuff, but no more using water to cook or anything.
Okay.
Oh my gosh. I read that and I was like, wait a minute. That's unsanitary. That's gonna be terrible. We're gonna end up with poopy knives over here, you know? Uh-oh, what do we got? We got the judges that are going like this.
She would have had the vodka. She could have just
sterilized. Oh, you do have vodka. Mm-hmm. You just sterilize everything. You got fire and vodka. Look at that.
What else do I need?
No, that's good. You could cauterize wounds and everything.
Yeah, perfect.
When you stab me.
Let's test this theory.
Oh, good. Thank you. I'm glad.
With my teeny tiny knife.
I'm glad that's happening. Instafluff, what are you doing here?
Gotta make scrambled eggs.
Okay. Can we smell what that smells like now?
It smells like pickled eggs.
It actually does. It does actually smell like pickled eggs, pretty much. I don't know how this is gonna come out tasting. Raphael, you might want to take a taste of it before you see how that came out.
Tastes like eggs.
Tastes like eggs, is what he says. Okay, perfect. We got another scoring category on the way out here, or we got the first scoring category that'll be on its way out in just a moment here. Chefs and judges. Oh boy. Now, that griddle's not even gonna be used, is it, Instafluff?
Nope.
And he puts it off to the side there. He's off his table. What do you got for us, Amanda? Water?
Close.
Oh, good.
Gin.
Same thing.
Ooh. Along with all-purpose flour.
Okay.
We also have a scoring category, and I've never seen this done, but I'm really excited for it, and it's symmetrical.
Symmetrical.
Great.
Did you have this one before?
Yeah.
Don't say symmetrical is what he had before.
Remember the shitty plant? It was triangular.
Triangular was the one you had last time, Dante. All right, so triangular was the last one, but this is symmetrical. So go with symmetrical. What? You're laughing at me over there. Dante's just laughing. Every time we have them on, both of you are just like stirring in your dishes. I just hear a lot of tapping around here. Echo, what are you even stirring right now?
I have taken my marshmallow.
Oh, wow.
And melted it with some vodka.
Ooh.
I'm going to see what happens when I put a little curry with it.
All right.
Ralph?
I wish I had a better reaction to that than, all right. But that's what I got right now. All right, let's see what Echo's, can we get a close up on Echo's face when she tries this?
It's odd. And not my favorite.
Okay, gotcha. So maybe this marshmallow fluff should be melted down and
more vodka.
Used as a side, used as like a little sauce on the side. I mean, you got 3 minutes left here. Is that gonna be enough time?
Yeah. I got
it. Also, Echo, make sure you rinse that spoon, because you put that in your mouth, and then you were planning on stirring again with it.
Well, yeah, but it's got to warm up first. I've been washing as I
Okay, she says she's been washing it, everybody. Don't worry. We got another scoring category coming out here for you in just a moment there. Actually, that marshmallow vodka mix actually smells really good. I got to say, it does.
It was great until the curry.
Yeah, it was good until the curry. Okay, it does smell pretty good, honestly. All right, what do you got for us, Charlie Amanda?
Charlie and Amanda. Purple Squad gave you some powdered mustard. And along with like two bacon bits.
Two bacon bits.
And the scoring category, along with symmetrical, is gonna be in space.
Ooh. Great. All right, we got 2 minutes left on the clock, judges, until we are chefs, until we are totally done, and that is it. So, judges, real quick, let's go to you real quick. Dante, we'll start with you this. Well, okay, what's happening, Dante? What are you doing over there?
I don't even know what in space
symmetrical
is.
And in space.
I don't, like, fuck.
All right, Bernice.
Well, symmetrical, I'm just going to say the food needs to look symmetrical.
Okay.
In space, I feel like you gotta send me to outer space.
Okay, it's gotta send you to outer space. Gotcha.
Never mind. I'll leave.
There is no recreational drugs in these dishes here. That's what you're looking for.
It's gotta be better in space food. Like they'd actually want to eat this in space. How about that?
Yeah. No. Okay. Got it. So out of a tube in a little goo coming out there. You might have that with echoes here.
All right.
I don't want to eat that.
chefs, you've got 1 minute, 15 seconds left. I would get to plating now if I were you. You've got very little time left.
We're on him.
Ooh, and then what do we got here on the stove? Echo, you've got some nice, ooh, the marshmallows are melting down pretty darn quick. And then what's going on in your pot back there?
Curry.
It's just curry. Echo, if you could plate up here.
Yes.
The best that you could. I know we only got 45 seconds left there.
I'm gonna be loud, deal with it.
And Insta-Fluff, what do you got going on over there? Wow, there's your pork and eggs.
Yes.
And with 38 seconds on the clock, here's a last ingredient. Oh, good, we got quinoa.
Last ingredient, butter and quinoa.
And we finally got
that took some 30 seconds.
And a measuring cup.
Thank you, Amanda. That was the last ingredient there. Thank you, everybody, for voting on this.
Super symmetric.
All right, you've got 18 seconds. You got to get that mushroom sauce or that, yeah, there we go. Yeah.
I am so sorry.
Oh, right on top of that cauliflower. 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Hands off. Go ahead and take those over to our judges, chefs. Great job, you two.
Oh my God, no. Oh,
this is what.
Sorry.
This is space pork. It's very symmetric, as you can see. We got our wasabi stars.
Wasabi.
With
okay.
Some planets of pork in the background and the horizon with the eggs. Sunny side up.
It looks like cat food.
I just gotta remind you, remember before your secret ingredient where you're like, there's nothing that could mess up.
So that's what we call like faking it till you make it, but I didn't quite make it. This is outer space curried pork. It basically looks like a psychedelic trip on your plate with a caramelized cauliflower, which is where you will find the forest ingredient. Enjoy. There's nothing symmetrical, I'm sorry.
I'm glad this is the last dish.
High five, yeah, we need some real food. Oh, sorry.
Echo, you were asking when did we get butter? You got that in the last, the 30-second round there. So everybody, that is the last round. Judges are gonna be over there. Go ahead and taste those dishes, judges. Rafael, how are you feeling about that, good?
It's great.
Echo, how do you feel?
Actually, I've been tasting the pork, and it actually came out really great.
Echo, how do you feel about that?
Curry's going to be great.
Curry's going to be great. All right, don't go anywhere, everybody, because we are going to be right back here after a brief intermission where we will talk to the chefs about their dishes, about that last one, and we'll get it from the judges, their final scores as well. Don't go anywhere. We'll be right back. Hey, everybody, and welcome back to Squad Says Served. My name is Ted's Friends, and wow, that was incredible, what we just saw. We're going to go through, so our judges are actually done judging already. We're supposed to be giving them enough time so that they're able to, like, go through all the dishes. They're already done with them. So let's go ahead and go through real quick, everyone's Echo hyping you in the chat there, Echo, with what looks like Will. Are those Will's emotes?
Yeah, those are the little friendo emotes.
friendo emotes. So let's go ahead and talk about
unicorns. Oh, there's my unicorns.
Let's talk about that first dish there. So the first dish out of all of these was the that one?
No,
that was not the
mug.
Yeah, where is yours? The mug. I didn't even register this as a dish. I was just like, oh, it's a cup. So let's go real quick about the mug real quick. What were y'all thinking about this dish here? How did this one turn out to you?
Oh man, that turkey, the ground turkey cooks really fast. It really, really, really fast. I didn't realize it was actually gonna cook so fast. And so I assumed it was kind of like ground beef, like burgers. And so I think it came out a little more dry than I expected.
Echo, how did you like your first dish? Quick rundown.
Okay, this one. It took me a minute to remember which one was the first one. I didn't have that much to work with.
That tends to be the case.
Yeah, but I'm happy with what came out of it. It's not like the most amazing thing ever, but I did what was asked of me.
Second dish, you guys had the turkey sausage, or the breakfast sausage, yes. I'm sorry. Now the turkey, I keep calling it turkey sausage, the breakfast sausage, it was a little bit better, I feel like. You had more ingredients to work with. How did you like yours? I liked the mushroom gravy and whatnot. Came out good on it.
Yeah, I hope so. I wanted to heat it up, but I couldn't figure out a good way to heat it up, and I didn't want it to like heat up and then just leave it where it starts burning. And so the timing of it was key.
Yeah, absolutely. Echo, how did you like yours? What do you think about it?
I'm pretty proud of it. I would eat the shit out of that with like some scrambled eggs on the side.
Nice.
Yeah.
Yeah, if you had eggs, that would have been nice.
I know.
Instafluff here got two eggs real late in the thing there. Number three, you want to talk about that one? What happened there, Instafluff?
Was it this one? Or
no, it was that one.
I was trying something new. It was a breakfast quesadilla with some cream cheese in the middle.
Yeah.
And I went for the, because I had to use the M&Ms. And so I figured, okay, well, I got a whole bunch of spices. How can I counterbalance that? And so I figured I could have a spicy powder and then a sweet powder to use with it.
Gotcha.
And so that was the idea. I don't know if it really executed that well. I also didn't have time to actually cook the outside, the tortilla.
Right.
He did. He just did. we all know you did. Don't lie there. You could have had. Echo, that could have been so bad.
Echo, how are you feeling about your fourth dish? Now, your fourth dish was the tacos.
Okay. It was really awesome. I already had some meat that I could throw in there and some extra veg that I added for a little bit more flavor. Thank you, Green Squad, for all the herbs that you gave me, just to give it a little. Yeah. And the only thing that was disappointing as I couldn't finish my little dessert crepe thing that I was trying to do. I was kind of trying to let that cook for as long as I could and then just quickly split it in half on the plates, but it just didn't work out with the timing.
Gotcha. And I feel like you got fucked on a lot of those forced ingredients. For the last dish, we want to hear from our judges here. Judges.
Second to last.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Sorry, from the chefs here. Talk about your second to last dish, and then we'll talk about the last dish.
Oh, yeah. Well, originally I wanted to make a hot dog out of the pizza crusts, and it turns out those thin pizza crusts don't really bend very well. They just rip.
Yeah.
And so I ended up making a pizza out of it. I also was running out of time at the end. I was like, oh, no, how do I plate everything on? So the idea was I wanted to put a little bit of the cheddar cheese on top, but I couldn't.
Looks good to me, honestly. And Echo, how about your fourth dish there? What did you think of that with the mint and the blueberries and the coconut, peanut butter?
Super happy about the dessert taco.
Yeah.
As soon as I saw that coconut and I had like some fruit and other things that were already in there, I was like, yes.
I thought it looked real good too.
Yeah, I definitely want to try that. I had a hot dog to work with. I don't know. I did the best I could, and I you know. It was a hybrid because it was a meat and man, and dessert tacos. Who does that?
I feel like if one of the scoring categories was for a seven-year-old, that would have been a lot better. That would have come out a lot better. A seven-year-old would just eat a plain hot dog there. Now, the final dish, those two in the middle there, judges. If you want to give your thank you for switching that over. They got. If you want to give your impressions of that final dish before we find out the winner there.
The eggs would have been good, I swear.
Yeah, so I mean, when I say this looks like cat food, I mean, I think my cat's food tastes better than this.
But it's symmetrical. That's what matters.
Oh. That's right. I did give you symmetrical. I'm very fair. I gave you symmetrical. But anything, I mean, like, I don't know how something can be so undercooked and overcooked at the same time.
It's fair.
On the curry, actually, I like the flavor.
Yeah.
I am thankful that I finally get some veggie today because it's all meat. So thankful for the cauliflower. And I think the curry tastes good.
Yeah. Ooh, all right. Dante, how are you feeling?
I'm the opposite of her. I hate curry.
Oh, wow. No kidding.
I don't eat curry, so.
But that's not Echo's fault.
Hold on. Curry. This is my opinion. Yeah. Yeah, I gotta vote, okay? I get to vote by myself, right? I don't care what nobody says. And you're not stopping me from the booth either. No, I'm just joking. But it was one of those where, for me, this was more of my kind of meal. I liked wasabi peas. I liked the presentation. It hit the idea. He even spaced out it. You know, he said he has planets and his moons and his sun. So he gave me a little pizzazz. But I had better flavor in the curry, even though I hate the curry.
So all right.
It did taste better than this cat food. I'll give him that.
All right.
He won presentation. He won style poisoning.
So with that, we are going to go ahead and go up to the front here now. Chefs, if you want to go ahead and take your places up in the front, we'll find out those final scores that we got from the judges. And we will award a belt. No, don't hold hands. You're competing teams. Don't hold hands. All right, what's happening? All right. So let's get from the production crew our final scores. 153 for purple. And 166 for green.
Yay!
Congratulations, Echo. Great job, Green Squad.
Echo's so
What is with the lights? They're flashing. No. Never had that before. We also want to award Green Squad. Oh, you get another spatula that you'll get to hang up on the Green Squad's wall. So great job. And so what that means is, because this is our final broadcast of December, that it ends in a tie between the two squads.
Wow.
Unfortunately. Just keeps on going up into the next, into the new year. We'll figure out a tiebreaker. We'll figure something out there. But so that means that we're ending this year currently in a tie. Great job, Echo. Go ahead and hang that up. We'll be back in just a second. We're going to take a very, very brief intermission real quick, and we'll be right back with Squad Says Chill. Don't go anywhere, folks. You can ask questions of anybody here. Ask about the future of the show, etc. Anything you want, and we'll be happy to talk to you about it. See you in a second. Perfect. Where did my water go? Hey, everybody, and welcome back. I get in my ear as I'm talking. You're good. Welcome back to Squad Says Chill. My name is Ted's Friends. Thank you, everybody, for joining us here. You just watched Squad Says Served, which you saw Echo over there on the end. That's Dante. No, Dante, don't stop it. Echo, who won over there. Thank you, Echo. So let's go ahead and go one by one. We'll give our socials out to everybody. Everybody, this is going to be your time to ask questions of everybody as soon as we go through and introduce everybody. So, InstaFluff, go right ahead.
Oh, hi, my name is InstaFluff. I stream Coding Cafe on Twitch every Wednesday, Thursday, Friday. It's easy to remember because it spells out WTF. And so it's Wednesday, Thursday, Friday mornings, we do chat integrated projects on code. And so we do things like Chat Translator, which is a Twitch bot that translates in real time any other messages or any languages into the streamer's language.
Awesome. That's amazing.
Yeah.
Bernice?
Hi, I'm Bernice. I am a stand-up comedian. You can look me up on social for Bernice Ye, like Y-E Kang Ye, Y-E. That's my last name. Yes.
Go ahead. We're going in a line. Yeah, I don't know why it's so hard to...
She was done. I've been talking so much. My name is Dante Barnett. I'm a comedian. It's like Dwayne in the T silent. I'm Dante17 on Twitter. Find me on Facebook. I'll be at Jai Thai, Comedy Underground, laughs all over.
Okay. I am Echo the Space Hippie, your favorite fun time professional unicorn friend, and current belt holder in SquadSays. Today kind of has marked the start of my glorious return to Twitch, so find me on Twitch at Echo the Space Hippie, and I'm looking forward to hanging out with you.
You might have the belt, but I finished the puzzle.
That puzzle on the end,
glorious.
We have Amanda.
Hi, I'm Amanda. Awkward Amanda or Amanders. I do makeup on Instagram and I live stream, so follow me everywhere at Amanders.
Look at how beautiful she is.
Okay, everybody, so this is the time where you can ask questions of anybody here. We'll be discussing those questions, answering those. I did see earlier somebody was making a joke that 4 = 3, Ted, and because they were counting how many little things were up there. The hammer does actually equal 2. That was a knockout there, or a hammer, as we'll
you
be calling
smashed.
It. You got smashed. Nice. So that is only given when the winning chef has won by 30 points or more. So that's a full dish that they've won by. And that did, in fact, happen. So Purple Squad did get a hammer. And so that's why it's ending in a tie. Otherwise, Green Squad would have come out on top there. Good job, Echo. You saved a victory there at the last second. So, folks, if you want to ask questions of these folks here, the chefs or the judges, please do ask. Are there any other utensils for bigger stompings? No.
No.
I don't know if there's a bigger stomp than a 30-point stomp, but I don't know. Okay, but if that wasn't Chris Hemsworth, I call shenanigans. Who was Chris Hemsworth? Who are they talking about in there?
Are you serious right now? Thor.
Oh, Thor. I get it.
Even I knew that.
I don't know. I don't know what they're talking about. Oh, my God.
Millennial over there. But even I got that.
Like, you win it. I like that from IsoCrid. You put a rake up if you win by 60 points. I like
a
that
full
idea.
Rake?
I love the idea of putting a full rake up there. That's hilarious. Judges, let's chat with you real quick, just because a lot of these dishes were pretty wild today. A lot of the times when we have different chefs that are on the show, we'll have like some very, very talented chefs. And then we'll have some, you know, amateur chefs, people who don't do a lot of cooking.
Or mug cooking.
He's a very good mug chef. He makes things in mugs. So what do you all think was the most thing, the dish that you sort of worried about the most today? Something that wasn't, that you saw and were just like, I'm not eating that. Besides all of them, Dante.
For me, it was this one. If she'd have left the shrimp flakes off of the extra shrimp flakes.
Yeah.
Because I couldn't deal with the smell, and then it ruined the sauce for me because she had shrimp flakes all over mine, and I just didn't like the shrimp.
That was a suggestion that I gave to her earlier, was I said, are you sure you want to put that? It's strong.
Like, she was like, no, it's fine.
Aroma was a judging category.
That's true.
You got a point.
But it was a bad aroma.
But it was an aroma.
That's my opinion.
Okay.
Perception.
All right.
Look here, you've been cooking. I challenge her. That's who I want to cook against. The little smart one.
Let's
over
do
there.
It.
She's a... Ooh, we got a question for Dante in the chat. So Dante, how many years have been taken off of your life in your time judging?
Oh, fuck. Oh, no. So you guys weren't here last time I did this, so you probably saw it. And I didn't eat. I felt like one of the deprived people across the border. We had squid.
Yep.
We had, what was the other ingredient? Oh, you heard that knock, yeah. We had squid, we had something else, so. Today, at least 3 or 4 years. At least 3 or 4 years.
Pokemon Hero says, Fluff gets a lot of advice, which is why I was rooting for Echo, even though I tried so much to sabotage her. So did you have Pokemon Hero on your squad or on Green Squad trying to sabotage you? Or was we've had a couple people doing that.
I don't think Pokemon is one of my crew, so I'm not sure.
For Echo, did they tell you that you were hype training the whole time?
No.
Apparently, I saw the spam, the Echo spam happening in there. We must have had some Will folk drop in there at some point. Yeah, see, there we go. Now they're doing that. I love that. Pokemon says they were on purple is what was going on there. Now, Dante, Bernice, did you enjoy your time on the show? Would you consider coming back? Let's say there was good chefs.
Oh, no, I love the bad chefs even more. When they're good chefs, you gotta be like nice and shit.
Yeah.
That was amazing.
Well, the thing is both of these chefs are actually good. I've seen, like, Echo is incredible at just cooking in general. Mm. And I've seen InstaFluff come out with some really wild and creative things as well.
Remember.
You like the pizza. No, you like it.
I like the pizza. Remember that. So, yeah, there's room here. The best part I felt for us is that the competitors got a chance to get judged because we were so opposite but the same on a lot of things that it gave balance for him to fuck up and her not to because I didn't like some of the shit she just cooked. So kept the score close at least, right? There's a handicap, right?
I love secretly Robin saying wild and creative. There is one time he was on this show and he took that pizza crust because it was a featured ingredient, I think, and he actually turned it into a quesadilla. It was so good. It was great. I thought it was awesome. Like, I would have never thought of that. But yeah, I watched him just turn it straight into a quesadilla. He does do wild and creative, secretly Robin.
I'm more scared because I've been judging so much, and I cook.
Yeah.
So now you guys are gonna bust my balls.
Only if
it's judges.
Only
when
if
cooking.
It's bad. Only if it's bad.
When
Who knows?
Cooking, I'm gonna tune in and I'm gonna sign up for whatever side you're not on, and I'm gonna let you know every time.
I'm trying to give you advice. I was trying to help you. Okay.
I had a lot of fun. I think the things look crazy. Some of them did not taste as bad as it looks. Some of them taste worse. I think my goal is really just tomorrow I don't get sick. I don't have food poisoning. Like Dante already know. This is my first time doing it, so I don't know yet.
Amanda, this was your first time being Trolley Amanda.
Yeah.
How was it doing that? I did this last time.
Yeah, well, since it was my first time, I don't know if that has anything to do with me doing it any other time, but I thought it was fun, exhilarating, a real life-changing experience. Yes.
Are you gonna cry today too, or no? Just
off camera.
And that says, well, remember the toilet can be your best friend.
Amen. Amen.
So every time I've done hosting and whatnot for this show, I always tried to give very small cooking advice to my chefs.
Not today, you're all over. Helping Fluff.
Me
too. Fluff, don't grate those too much. Hey, maybe you should do this. Hey, here's a lifesaver. Somebody listen.
Oh, man. Well, that was the thing.
It's a handicap. We got to keep it competitive. I'm sorry.
I feel like since I have a basic knowledge of cooking that I can at least say, like, hey, maybe you don't put those, like, shrimp things in there too much. Or, like, for example, when I mentioned InstaFluff, maybe you should cook those tortillas before you serve them.
Hey. He was like, nah, they're fine.
They're room temperature.
They're not cold, they're room temperature.
You know what I mean? You know what I mean? Basic knowledge of cooking that maybe would have helped. But it was just funny. You're just like, yeah, no, they're room temperature. They're fine. Yeah.
And when you told them you're going to start your thing now, you're going to do your pork shoulder now, you don't even know what you're going to have with it.
Yeah,
don't worry about that.
Well, that's the thing. Pork shoulder is something that would take a while to cook, which is why Echo had hers in that stew or in that curry for a long time. But I do feel like you every time I turned to you, you had the heat up all the way and the pork was under there. I'm like, what are you doing?
I'm sitting over there, I'm like, you've got some oil, you've got a cast iron skillet. That pork shoulder has a fat side. Mm-hmm. Just throw that on the fat side on the pork cast iron skillet when you started and it would...
That explains so much.
Yeah. I need to let you know, I don't think I would be any better than you were today. I don't think I would do any better on this show than you did. But at least I would have warmed my tortilla up. At the very least.
I needed the microwave. That was my biggest handicap.
Doubtful guest. I can't read.
Maybe.
I don't know where my glasses are. Amanda reminds me of Anna Kendrick.
Everyone says that.
Really? I've never.
Everybody.
Who's that?
Anna Kendrick. She's like
perfect.
A.
Yep, pitch perfect.
She's really cool. She's awesome. She's super pretty.
She's really, yeah. She's
obviously, she must be gorgeous.
She's like real mousy looking.
What?
Yeah.
Never mind. I'm not in this.
Pork shoulder needs to be braised or cooked low and slow.
That's
to
what
break
I said.
Down all the connective tissue, or it will be rubber, is what they're saying.
Good advice. Yeah.
They're saying, oh, Mags here says, do I see another gold spatula on green? You do. Mags, that is a victory for the Green Squad. That means that Green Squad has tied Purple Squad in the end. There will be a tiebreaker at some point. We'll announce that. But we'll see when that happens there.
And by the way, she made hot dog somethings. They may not have been squids, and they definitely weren't men. But I don't think I'm supposed to tell you what
well,
they look like.
Well, I mean, technically. I mean, technically.
Wieners?
I didn't say anything.
No, that's fine.
Wieners.
No, you say know, it, when I was sitting there cutting them, I'm like, oh, wow, yeah, this is unfortunate looking, but I've already committed to this.
How do you say it? It looks like a flaccid penis. I think that's the way you say it.
Yeah. That sounds disgusting. Like, I can't tell from here, but okay. Echo's looking it up.
I said, okay.
They're heart-shaped.
Yeah, it looks like a dude's pancake.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah, that's pretty bad. But coding content soon, I hope. What? Are they talking to you? Is that what we're doing on the channel now? That MS Gamer, do you know them?
Yeah, they're
Oh, okay, yeah, they're asking for that. So coding content now, Echo, content. I'm sorry, Instaplug. I mix my names up all the time. Hey, Dante, that's a delicacy.
Oh, no. Gross. Oh, no.
I want to thank everybody for being here, because they really just like, they basically made these dishes. And I was like, I don't know what to cook if they're just putting them here.
And that's the whole idea behind the channel is, you know, that the squads are the ones who get to vote, they're the ones who get to decide. You know, all of the ingredients that you get, all the sabotages, all the scoring categories, everything that happens is a direct result of the squads. It's a lot of like, I've seen it, you know, somebody compared it to playing basically Twitch Plays Chef is a good way to describe it, or at least this game. And, you know, in the future, we do have plans for doing other type of community controlled content, you know, so that's something to look forward to in the future there, folks.
Yeah, but, so make sure you guys follow.
Yeah, please do. If you haven't already, please do consider following and whatnot. I love this channel because we get to make everyone suffer in different ways. It's pretty much, yep, that's what I hear a lot of. That's what I hear a lot of. So, chefs, so these out of these five dishes that you cooked here today, was there anyone that you were very confident with in general or more confident with than the others? Like, it was an ingredient you'd worked with plenty before. Don't say wieners, I know.
I'll just say this.
What's that?
I mean, I'm deeply offended, sir.
Everything.
Curry cubes.
Oh.
Those got me so excited. I cook with those all the time. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. And as soon as I saw those, I knew I was just going to make a curry with the pork shoulder and just throw that all together. And then people just kept sending me perfect veggies to go with it. And it was awesome. So thank you, everybody, Green Squad.
Is Pokemon Hero one of your viewers? Oh, yeah. Gotcha. Sadly, Fluff was excited for the things he showed you.
Amen, Pokemon Hero! Yes, wasabi beans! What am I doing with
beans? They're actually really good. I'm a big wasabi fan.
I know that, but about 20 minutes later, what am I doing with these again?
Oh man, that turned out so good. What about you? What was one of the ingredients that you'd worked with a ton that you were, and don't say wieners.
Eggs in a mug.
Eggs in a mug, gotcha.
Yeah, that's pretty much it.
I mean, you did microwave those eggs. I've never seen somebody microwave an egg before when they have like a burner available to them. What's up, Amanda?
When I was younger, and back when I ate eggs, I would always cook them in the microwave. This sounds really gross, but it was really good. You just put one egg in a bowl in the microwave for a minute, and also a slice of American cheese.
Yeah, it's so good.
Yeah, thank you. You're the only other person I know who's ever cooked eggs in the microwave, and I thought it was pretty good.
With American cheese?
So yeah. I have to say something because I'm the only one who are allowed to say it. Like, every Asian guy I know does it that way.
What? Really?
Yeah, they actually.
You're so racist, dude.
I know.
Bullshit.
It's only true because it's my experience. I'm not saying everyone is every Asian that I know does that.
Really?
Yeah, and then, like I also seen the crop of newspaper of recipe of microwave eggs with cheese and like put in a cup in a mug.
Wow.
Yeah.
I didn't know I was the only Asian guy that she knew.
You say you don't do comedy. Your comedy's better than cooking, at least.
God damn. Oh, fuck. No, InstaFluff has been a very popular guest that we've had on the show here. He's always calm, collected. He's always hilarious in a very, like, deadpan way. See, that's what I mean. Like, you just sort of, like, go with it.
We need to flop this show and have them judge us. That's what we need to do next. Because we're going to cuss each other out. I'm pretty sure Bernice is pretty competitive
here.
Oh,
man. Eggs in the microwave is evil. Is it, though? I used to do it when I couldn't cook with a stove. I don't know what's easier than an egg on a stove. I feel like it just tastes better, too. Like,
well, sure, but if it's your only option, you know, eggs in a microwave is all right.
Yeah, yeah, you get a little. Oh yeah, that's true.
The hard part about that giant pan is like it's really heavy.
That's super heavy.
So you can't actually like flip the egg or anything.
Right.
The other one, the square one, actually has a whole bunch of like these grid line things that are popping it up, and so you can't just like fry it easily.
Right.
It'll stick to it.
Why do you need to flip it if you're making scrambled eggs?
If I had a frying pan, I wouldn't make scrambled eggs.
Right, but you made scrambled eggs is what I'm saying.
Yeah, well.
You had a pan and you had a spatula, which you could have like, I don't think you had butter though.
He didn't have time.
No, you didn't have time. What's that, Echo?
I had butter.
You had butter at the last 30 seconds.
The last 10 seconds.
I loved that. Oh man, was just Amanda coming out while they're frantically plating. Here's your butter. Here's couscous.
10 seconds left. Here's quinoa. Measuring cup and some butter, just in case you need those right now.
Oh man, that's so good. When I did cook eggs in the microwave, I would scramble them and add string cheese. I mean, it's just mozzarella. Ooh. It's just processed a different way.
Yeah.
I mean, please take Fluff and teach him comedy. Because what is food.
Shit, I mean, this got real.
Wow.
You come with me. We're doing Chai Town on Tuesdays. Come on.
He's good at doing the mug recipes, though. That's like a staple of your content.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. There was
you get a lot of viewers, too.
Screw that. I challenge Pokemo Hero to come cook better than him. That's what I want to see.
It's tough. I will say, it is not easy. Like, Mike and I, the other host of the show, him and I had to do a cook-off where we had to cook eggs, and he tried to cook an omelet. Well, I just made some like nice scrambled eggs with some butter, a little bit of cheese in them, and that was it. I did no frills. But like in those 10 minutes that we got to cook
you lost your shit.
Yeah, no. It was so tough.
You're looking over, you're sweating.
Yeah.
Shit, 6 minutes left. Sorry, I got it.
It's like you freak out. You're just like, I don't know what I'm gonna do. This is and there's Mike. The Mike Robles is actually in the chat watching right now.
It's like changing a diaper. It's like, fuck, I only had so much time to do this. Let's get this done.
Well, the issue that he did was he took Gouda and put that in there. So salty that we had a professional chef from France here. Who was judging the food, and she got to judge my scrambled eggs and his omelet. She did. She just said it was too. She just said it was too salty. Pretty much. That's why I won, Mike. That's why I won. And it's at In-N-Out with you, is what Kevin says. Ooh. So let's say, I just want to put that out there. In-N-Out's the best burger place on the West Coast.
Don't get
right?
fucked up.
It's so good.
Dicks,
so
bitch. We're in Seattle.
Yes.
Knicks, bitch.
Knicks.
Don't get beat up. Mike, you might be hosting next week. You paying attention?
Have you all been to Southern California to have In-N-Out?
Yes. I've been to Vegas.
You all are wrong.
Yeah, fuck you.
I never disagree.
Harold and Kumar went to White Castle. Like, they tried.
All right, nobody agrees with White Castle here. I don't know if
I can't lie, they're cheap.
They are really, really
cheap. Back when I was in. Fuck. Anyways, back in my day, you know, you could get the little White Castles for 39 cents a piece, and fuck, that was the best munchy drunk food in the world.
Everybody is saying dicks. Just saying dicks now in our chat.
Oh,
dicks.
No.
They're actually like, dicks is really good.
A greasy bag of dicks in their life.
This is the only place where you can tell somebody to eat a bag of dicks and it's not an insult.
Mike is saying here, dicks is drunk good. In-N-Out is actual food.
Oh, wow. Ooh. If we were talking about that, then Shake Shack.
Oh, wow.
Goodness.
A lot of, five
we've
tier one subs.
Six of them, yeah.
Oh, nice.
Woo!
Yay. Congratulations, guys, on the gift sub.
In-N-Out is all you need for your life. Oh my God, it's delicious stuff. I'm glad that I've turned the conversation away from the show, and now it's a debate about
just
the best fast food.
Well, that's Kevin's favorite restaurant, actually.
In-N-Out?
Mm-hmm.
It's so good.
No,
I love In-N-Out.
Stop. I lied. Five Guys.
No, overrated and pricey.
Oh my God,
no,
spicy.
No.
Overrated and pricey.
I agree.
I don't want to be on the show anymore. I'm done, that's it.
Oh my God,
it's a Shake Shack. It's a Shake Shack.
There's actually, ooh, Shake Shack is good.
An emote for this on Twitch. But after 9 p.m.,
hey,
you go to Jack
weeks,
in the Box.
2 weeks, I see it too. I like your hybrid
so good.
Meal
have these
idea
munchie
too.
Meals.
Come on, nobody likes Shake Shack? Come on.
Five Guys, I'm shutting off his mic. Screw you, Kevin.
The munchie meals at Jack in the Box are so good.
Hold on, I just had in my ear production Steve saying, I'll make you a better burger than any of those.
Well, obviously.
I bet he could, honestly. Steve is good at like those, he's good at like nachos, burgers, you know, foods like that, grilling foods, I would assume. Foods that make you fat is what he said in my ear there.
But that's
if you're
not
in
fair.
Washington, the best burger is actually at Herphy's.
Herphy's okay. In Redmond?
No, in White Center.
Ooh.
Ooh.
You guys
now, they use the they use the Hawaiian roll, right? And then it's not ground beef, it's ground
lamb?
Ribeye.
Ground turkey?
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
I'm a big ribeye guy,
yeah,
too.
It's the real fucking burger.
That sounds good.
They've got the old sodas, the old shakes, the old malts.
I cut off Dante's mic and nobody could tell. Everyone else's mic picks up in his bass filled voice. Oh man.
I don't know why there's
no, here's the thing.
Sorry,
it's getting loud in my ear there. I don't know why. But Five Guys is not the best. I don't agree. It's just it's pricey. The burgers are fine. It's just really expensive for what it is. You can get like a 4x4 at McDonald's.
I love the way the guy said ground beef is ribeye. No, there's a difference between ground beef
chuck.
And yeah.
Generally, most ground beef you're getting is ground chuck.
Yeah, it's not ground
beef. I know, I was a butcher's assistant.
It's all murder.
My first job, remember? Pokemon Hero, thank you for gifting another sub out there to secretly Robin. That's very much appreciated.
And Kevin Puck.
Local burger talk is where your knives come out from soul and face.
Whoever
there.
Said vegan burgers best just vegan lost burger. Their life.
You know what? No. I want to say I love black bean burgers. I think a black bean burger is real good.
Bite me.
It's delicious. All right, Amanda, you're a vegan and you are gluten-free. You can eat beans.
Oh, shit.
You can eat, you're gluten-free due to issues, but.
Issues.
The thing is like black bean burgers are good, right?
Yeah, I prefer fake meat though. Beyond Burgers, if you guys,
Beyond Burgers.
Beyond Meat,
yeah.
You should try that, Dante, really if you good. Haven't. It's amazing. Everyone I know who eats meat and has eaten that says that it is good. So you might want to try it.
Katsu burger.
And it's actually more
so is that
delicious.
What I'm cooking?
Oh, yeah, it's so much
cook,
better for you.
Is you guys gonna have those burgers in here for me to cook? Is that what I'm going to have? Already
Impossible Burger, yeah. Someone said an Impossible Burger and that's legit.
Mm-hmm. Ooh, yeah.
Jack in the Box tacos are vegetarian.
Ooh, he brought up a really good thing. The after 9 o'clock going to Jack in the Box where they have the munchie meals.
Oh, fuck. That's the worst thing in the world.
Oh, they're so good.
2 a.m.
They're so good.
You mean I can get a fried grilled cheese sandwich on top of my burger?
With two tacos?
What?
Yeah,
and two tacos? Three of everything on the menu for $6? Fuck yeah, give me two.
It's so cheap. And you get fries and curly fries.
That's what I'm
saying.
You get different fries. Give me two.
It's amazing. But I will make black bean burgers sometime for everybody here because they are really good. I follow a recipe from Sam the Cooking Guy in San Diego. It's like a local celebrity down there. They're very, very good. With a little aioli sauce on top of them, they come out very good.
You rich bitch, it's called mayonnaise.
You called it aioli earlier. You did.
I'm wearing a suit. I'm supposed to say hello.
Okay, my fault. Okay, my
so
fault.
So somebody mentioned Katsu Burger. Was that you?
I haven't been to Katsu.
Oh my God, it's so good.
The tofu burger is really good. Yes. The honey meat.
Okay, that's where we're going. Afterwards.
I know East Stooge. I was giving you a hard time. I'm sorry.
Tofu burger?
Yeah, they have a honey miso tofu burger.
Where can I get this?
At Katsu Burger.
Where is this? There's one in Cap Hill. All right. I think there's one somewhere else, but I don't know.
There's one in down in like near White Center.
Okay.
I think they also opened one in Bellevue.
Nice.
Awesome. You know a lot about Y Center.
This Everything episode brought to you by
Katsu. I look for the
Brought to you by
there,
just
yeah.
burgers in general.
They're saying Bougie Ted strikes again.
Yeah, exactly. Aioli.
Hey,
That's the exact tone. Aole.
Aole.
Capers. Oh man, you said aole.
Harambe.
There's one in
Linwood.
Oh, there's one in Linwood as well, apparently. So that's actually really nearby. Habit has really good burgers. Overrated. Habit's fine. Habit burger's fine.
I don't know if you saw it, but she almost spit out her water.
Did she really? What'd you do to her?
When I said Harambe.
Folks, if you have any more questions, please do ask that in the chat. We will get to those. We will answer those. I don't know if you guys had anything else you really wanted to talk about. We got into a big discussion about burgers
right there
for no reason. We were supposed to talk about the show, and I just went, derail, let's go off this direction.
Hey, we had more comments when we talked about burgers than anything else.
So yeah, we did.
Jesus. No, don't you talk about burger my fucking episode? Burger, bitch, no.
Oh, yeah, there was actually a place near Seattle University called the, it was called the Happy Grillmore. They actually had some really good burgers.
Is it still there?
Yeah.
Oh, okay, good. Well, the way you said it made it seem like. How do you guys make your steaks?
I don't.
You don't?
What?
That's what somebody in the chat was asking.
Sorry. Medium. I was like, who?
Medium. Medium to medium rare.
Corn is not a valid pizza topping. Let's see. What did Echo? How do you make your steak?
Like, if it moves when I poke it, I'm happy.
Okay. Dante?
So, Squid Zerf, it's Dante, but it's still Duante. So, it's the second one. So, it looks like Dwayne with a T in the middle. I go, medium rare.
Okay. Well, I don't make steak myself, but I make Korean barbecue. So, bulgogi or like ribs. So, yeah. It's more like a medium to like a little bit toward down. Yeah.
Medium. Always medium.
Medium?
Yeah.
What?
Pokemon had a good question. He asked, where do we start off as comedians, or is it in?
Yeah. Hold on. I want to get to my steak first. I cook it medium rare.
Nobody cares about your steak.
It's medium rare, but I cook it the method of the reverse sear. So, okay, go ahead.
You boozy. What is the fucking reverse sear? There you go.
It's basically a method where you.
What the fuck?
It's basically a method where what you do first is you you bake it in the oven, and then you take it out and you. Sear the edges.
That's what I do. Yeah, you bake.
Or I'm sorry, I think it's opposite. No, you sear all the edges and then you throw it in the oven.
I want
to. There's a specific method to it.
It's so baked then sear. Yeah. Baked then broil.
It's, like that, it's the like, best way. It's the best way to cook a steak.
It's like that scientific one where like you put it in this
sous
vide. Pressured. Yeah.
Yeah.
I want to try that.
Yeah, we vacuum
it. It's basically boiling it. Yeah. It's boiling meat.
Wow.
All right. Good. So they asked, where did you get your starts in comedy?
I'd say probably for both of us, it's about. It's honestly about your dark past, honestly. I do all my comedy about who I am, what I've been through, being mixed, being a dad, trying to date, be single, being black. Pretty sure you'll agree most of your comedy is about your life experience. Mm-hmm. So, you know, if a million people tell you you're funny, eventually you decide to get up there and see if you are.
Yeah, I mean, for me, I didn't come from this country, right? So, like, for me, I think about my life experience, I think it's funny, but the biggest barrier for me is English is not my first language. So for the longest time, I feel like I couldn't do it. But when Ali Wong came out and when I also just went to some stand-up comedy class, if you're asking the class, I can give you more information. Went on the stage, people loved the material, talking about my life in China. I lived in Indiana when I first came here, and also become a US citizen, so there's a kind of a my life story, yeah.
Awesome. I didn't happen to see if there were any other questions on there.
No, I think that was about it.
That was about it, it was just asking how you started
comedy. They asked it once, then he asked again, we've been good.
Oh, good, good. I'm glad we actually got to it. Sous vide is not boiling.
Oh, shit.
Sous vide I mean, is like the magic meat machine.
And he's really not mayonnaise either, but oh God, come on.
Asking about comedy is a big missed mistake.
Wow.
Oh, shit.
Jesus Christ!
It is about that one. Okay, we back to
everybody just like
I don't have enough gin for this.
She drank all her gin. Fuck!
I know.
Did you really drink There's the gin out of that?
Gin is delicious.
Thank you, Robin. Love you, dude.
Oh man. All right. So let's go ahead since we're sort of slowing down on there. People are asking a little bit less questions. If they ask something, we'll. We're going to raid the famous here in just a couple minutes here.
The famous.
So if you all want to go one by one and we will give your socials out and say goodbye to everybody, go ahead, InstaFluff.
All right. Guys, my name is InstaFluff. If you guys enjoyed what we do here, make sure to follow us. I'm InstaFluff on Twitch and InstaFluff TV on Twitter.
My name is Bernice Ye. So really enjoying being here the first time. Maybe I will come back as a cook sometime. So my Instagram is Bernice Ye Jing. J-I-N-G is my real Chinese name. And then on Facebook is Bernice Jing Ye. So you will find me either way.
My name is Dante Barnett, stand-up comedian. In about 2 weeks, I got my daughter till Christmas Eve. So between Christmas and after for that next 2 weeks, I'll be all over the place. Find me on Facebook, D-U-A-N-T-E Barnett. Same with Instagram, Twitter. Come have a laugh and have a smile.
I'm so proud of you for making a Twitter and Instagram.
Oh, I'm one of those old fuckers. See, y'all don't know. I didn't have a Twitter and Instagram 3 weeks ago, so all these guys talked me into getting one. So I got one now.
Yay! Woo! All right, I am Echo the Space Hippie on Twitch. I am your favorite unicorn fun time friend. This has been a blast, and I won! Yay! And tomorrow, I am going to be starting streaming on my Twitch channel again, so come hang out, 10 a.m. PST. I will play an game and make you smile. Yay!
You can subscribe to my YouTube, which is Awkward Amanda, and you can follow me on Instagram and Twitter and Snapchat or anywhere at Amanders. And thank you for watching.
And my name is Ted's Friends. You can follow me on Twitter at Friends of Ted or on Twitch at Ted's Friends. Don't go anywhere because we're gonna raid the famous here in just a moment. And we'll see you in the new year, folks. Every Tuesday from 7 o'clock to 10 o'clock.
Merry Christmas and Happy New Year.
Goodbye, everybody.
Happy Christmas. Bye.